Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. We are here at the Orange Bowl with Shannon Davis and Greg Krause for the Fredonia Hillbillies versus the Southwestern Trojan Showdown.
Big game tonight, Shannon. There's all sorts of things heaped into this. The one seed in the balance, the league, the bragging rights, but most important,
it's Christmas in October, Greg!
I knew you were going there right off the bat. Yep.
The Christmas presents are out. The fans, the Christmas sweaters, the costumes. But in all seriousness, this is the game of 2021 for the Fredonia Hillbillies. The players marked it on their schedules, and there it is, Greg. You can see the student section with all the Santa hats. All right, it's a big deal, and I'll tell the story later. All right, little backstory
Or truncated, I guess, is that over summer there was some play during the passing league, and some things were said, and it was about Christmas and presents, and it's just blown up from there.
It has. It's one of those things with Christmas. So, passing league, you know, Southwestern Fredonia, there's been a lot of rivalry for years. It's a Southwestern-dominated rivalry recently, too. Don't put that aside. You know, they have dominated Fredonia for years. But in passing league this summer, first offensive possession of Southwestern, there might have been an interception. Aiden Kennedy was intercepted by Matt Lauder, and Matt Lauder had some fun with it, ran down the sideline saying, Christmas presents, it's Christmas early, and it has taken off. It's been on Twitter, it's been coaches, it's been this, it's been that, and here we are, and now the student section is dressed up like it's December 24th.
You know, it's funny. The great thing about it is it's energized the players, it's energized the fans, it's energized, you know, everybody around, you know, and by the way, both sides, Southwestern knows what's going on, you know, it just adds to an already, you know, hot rivalry that now we've just added a little something else to it. Now, you know, as a guy, I hope we haven't tweaked the wrong guy in that, as we were talking about before the game, Aiden Kennedy is a gamer. You know,
absolutely.
I mean, he's a player.
And Matt Lauder.
Totally. Yeah. But, you know, Southwestern's a proud group. They've had a lot of success, and they certainly, they're going to feed off it as well. I think we're in for a great game.
Absolutely. So what's on the line tonight? So let's talk about this, all right?
Yeah.
Fredonia comes in undefeated in the league and for overall for the season. Southwestern has one league loss to Salamanca by 1 point. Salamanca has one league. They beat Southwestern. They have one league loss to Fredonia, went to Salamanca last week and put on a show and won by plus 20, all right, which is a huge thing in playoffs. But right here, right now, tonight, this is first place on the line. Southwestern wins this game. They jump from being out of the playoffs to the one seed. Fredonia wins this game. They pretty much lock up, unless there's some major upsets in the last couple league games against Casadega Faulkner and Chautauqua Lake. They lock up one seed.
I would agree with you on the first on the second part. Fredonia wins today, you know, short of a letdown, they lock up the one seed. But once again, Southwestern wins. Now we've got a three-way tie. You know, by the way, Southwestern wins today. We're all real big Salamanca fans because we need them to stay as a one-loss team.
Right.
So that now there's 3-4-1. Head-to-head, all of a sudden, isn't quite as important. It's now comes down to let's look at the league and that point differential. Now remember, it's a 20-point max point differential. So it's whether you win by 21 or 41,
50, yeah, right.
It's just a 20 point. So Fredonia's maxed themselves out every game so far.
Absolutely. And that was huge against Salamanca last week. Really, anytime Southwestern, Salamanca, or Fredonia has played nine, any other one else in the team has been plus 20 all year long. It's the three powerhouses in the league, and there's really everyone else at this point. So this is just a huge game. It was circled early. You know, we're just praying it lives up to the hype from the city. We're going to take a quick pause for the national anthem here.
So as we get back, it's funny. I looked across and I said, "Oh, look, the cheerleaders are dressed like." But that's just their wonderful colors and their shiny pom poms. But for a second, I thought they were coming right back at it.
No, but I will say this:
if you know, and we'll talk about this as the game goes on. But it's not as much of a doomsday because Fredonia's got that one game in hand. With the Salamanca win and the and Southwestern losing to Salamanca, so it gets complicated.
Winning by plus 20
right.
against Salamanca,
right.
So even if they lose tonight but lose by less than 20,
scenarios where where it could. So but, it's not as easy as just. But it's kind of like I tell you, we've been talking Bills and KC, another huge game this weekend for most of us from here, and we talked about how you know, hey, if KC loses. They're in big trouble. If Southwestern loses, they're in big trouble.
Absolutely.
If the Bills lose, they still got some, you know, I mean, they got a schedule coming up, and they you know, they've got some different things that are going. And so Southwestern really, really needs this game.
Yeah, they do. And you know, I will say this, and you brought up Aiden Kennedy. He's a stud. We're not going to.
He's a gamer.
And he's a gamer.
Three-sport gamer.
And he's done nothing but win games for Southwestern. And he's out here leading this team. He's number 18. You're going to see him throwing. You're going to see him running. And I guarantee you, you will see him make plays tonight. You know, on the other hand, you have Nick Whitfield at quarterback.
Oh,
another stud, right?
Yep.
Absolutely. But he's never beat Aiden Kennedy in football. All right. In football.
Yep.
Basketball and baseball, yes. Football, no. So there is that mental edge Southwestern has over Fredonia right now coming in. It's been years since the Fredonia varsity team has beaten Southwestern. So even though they're favored tonight, Southwestern has the edge. And they did something different I've never seen them do tonight. They usually come out all sorts of hype. We saw them 2 years ago planting the field, middle of the field, blah, blah, blah. A crazy lining up and doing warm-ups in the middle of Fredonia. They didn't even warm up on the field tonight, Greg. They came out here early, and they've stood in those spots that we can see them in right now since they got on the field. And that's an interesting development we have not seen out of Southwestern in a long time.
I wonder if any, you know, Jim Barber, our referee today, is about to flip the coin. We're going to find out who's getting it first. But I wonder if the officials are aware enough. I know you had a quick conversation with one of them, but, you know, it's one of those things, if you're a basketball official, I know, you know, some of the games that I've done even as a get control early.
Absolutely. And they did. They
did
get
out of control.
The officials are right in between the two teams. Again, Southwestern didn't even come out on the field.
Yeah.
Normally they do. So let's see here. Fredonia is
kicking.
To kick off here.
I assume they won the toss.
Yeah,
and
deferred to the second half. Or, I mean, Southwestern may want the ball. I don't know. It's hard to say. Okay, you're right, Greg. So Fredonia won the toss. They are deferring, and they are going to kick off. So you're going to see Aiden Kennedy in the Southwestern Trojan offense on the field first. You know, and let's see. I mean, that's a you know, Fredonia gets the ball, starts second half, but, you know, Southwestern gets the ball, drives down the field, and scores easily. That could be really a psychological blow from Fredonia, although they've come from behind all year, you know, multiple times this year. But not against Southwestern. You know, Southwestern has that edge over them. So this is a huge start to the game. We've been looking for this game all year long. My shoulders have been tense all day long, Greg, with two sons playing this game. You're more nervous than ever, right? So, by the way, keep me under control tonight.
I got the seatbelt.
All right, Keto, bring it back in. I'm not allowed to say anything about the field tonight, even though it's not nice. But it looks
it's
good.
It's in as great a shape as it is for an October game.
Absolutely. And I will give the Beaver Club some credit. That is a beautiful scoreboard. We can actually see the score being correct now for the first time in years. So thank you very much to the Beaver Club for that. Thanks to Chip Rewald and our staff for having us here. And
we got Chip today running the show. He's on the booth. We got Jackson Hickey and Anthony Derby.
And you want to give the officials a quick shout-out before we kick off,
too? So today, Jim Barber is our referee. Len Camello is the umpire. Reggie Taylor is the head linesman. And Chad Bongiovanni is the line judge.
All right, kicking off, and I don't think either team is going to kick it deep tonight. Fredonia has two kickoff returns for touchdowns this year, and Southwestern is known for their little games that they play on the kickoff, too. So here we go, folks, and it is a short kick. Right, it lands right around the 25, scooped up. And it's going to be swarmed by a slew of Fredonia tacklers right away.
19-yard line. Great kick.
Yeah. Great kick.
You're talking about placing and, you know, sitting. You know, that ball just sat where it went, and you're right. They didn't kick it to him.
No, and that's the strategy. Coach Steve Johnson is the special teams coach. He comes in. You know, we had Nick Johnson played for Fredonia years ago, was a punter at Rutgers himself. So there's a lot of special team insight there. And I know for a fact that they kick it out of bounds, it goes out of bounds. They do not want to give up that big return.
They are right on the 20. Might as well kicked it out of the end zone, right? Yeah. They're right on the 20-yard line.
Absolutely.
Here we go.
So you got Aiden Kenny's number 18, starting quarterback. You got number 8, Jamison Walls, sophomore, leading running back. But you're going to see Kennedy himself run it a lot. And there it is. Start the game in an average gain about – he's going to get
maybe 5.
4 or 5 yards. So, again, if you're an offense, that's a good first down play. Not a flashy play, but that's Aiden Kennedy. Aiden Kennedy on the year rushing. I'll give you some stats real quick because we didn't get a chance.
Fredonia really is, I mean, in their defense, boy, that free safety is deep today.
Yeah, and you're going to see, and there's McCall dropping back. So
15 yards, you know, deep off the – and look at this spread offense.
It's interesting.
Very different.
And he's giving it out to number 4. Completes the pass. Breaks one tackle. Completes a number 4 of Southwestern. So that is Matt Panties, who is the leading receiver for Southwestern. 16 catches on the year for 213 yards and a touchdown. So it's going to bring up 3rd down. Nice tackle open field by Matt Cash. Second leading tackler behind Matt Lauder, the two middle linebackers of Fredonia.
Coming out with an offset eye.
And you got one-on-one coverage out here. Davis to the right. Keep an eye on that. It's going to be a run play to Walsh.
Not getting it.
And there is nothing there. And Fredonia is going to force 4th down. Maybe a gain of 1 there. Great job by that defensive line.
I can't imagine.
The punt team is coming on, but
who
ran
that ball?
That was Walsh, I believe.
Yep.
And it looks like it's almost looks like a 0. Interesting at all that they're punting. They have one guy back, and it's Ethan Fry. Usually have Simon Davis back returning punts, but Ethan Fry, the safety, is doing it today. But Kennedy is going to do a punt. It's a short line drive. It's going to be no return. It's not even going to make it to the 50, right around the 49-yard line. So great job by the Fredonia defense, Greg, and great starting field position for the Fredonia offense at the, as you're talking about the 48-and-a-half, really, but... just shy of the line drive. It's going to be no return. It's not even going to make it to the 50, right around the 49-yard line. So great job by the Fredonia. Great starting field position for the Fredonia offense. Fredonia, I don't know if any team's going to want to give up returns today. So we'll see that. It's going to be real interesting. You and I talked about this. Fredonia calls
Twins
a lot
left,
of plays
spread,
at the line to scrimmage.
They got the pistol.
It's a pistol, yep. Yeah. Lauder behind Whitfield. Lauder's going to get the ball early in a big hole right off the middle. Gain of
9.
Close to 8 yards, maybe 9, by Lauder. He wasn't touched, so 4 or 5 yards down the field. And Fredonia at the line of scrimmage has the size advantage over the Southwestern line. There's no doubt about that. You got Sean Farnham and Izzy Martinez at the bookend tackles. We're both giant young seniors.
I was looking for Southwestern has one player over 200 pounds.
And there's Lauder again, and he's going to get the first down. Tackled from behind. That's number 21 of Southwestern. That's Cameron Link on the tackle. And what a difference. Last week, Lauder didn't get a carry to the second half. Salamanca was crowding the box. Tonight, he comes out and he gets the first 2 carries on the first 2 snaps of from offensive line of scrimmage for Fredonia. Trips left this time.
Total spread. Well, pistol, no tight.
Whitfield's keeping it this time. He's going to go.
He's gone.
He is gone. Nick Whitfield, what a zone keeper there. It's going to be about a 37, 38-yard touchdown.
Just a great call. I mean, you know, the zone read.
Here
what
it
a read
is
by
on
Whitfield.
The replay.
Yep,
nice block by Davis. Downfield.
Spun
no,
it.
Untouched, Greg. Untouched into the end zone. But I will say, last year at Southwestern, Fredonia's first possession looked a lot like this. Easy touchdown, Whitfield rushing, and they Southwestern took over at that. So, you know, long from being over here, but what a great start for Fredonia. Sal Tabone on for the extra point attempt, who has been a real weapon for Fredonia. Coming over as a soccer player, as a kicker, and the attempt is up, and it is good, making the score. Fredonia 7. Southwestern 0, 8:38 in the first quarter, and what a start for Fredonia so far.
Yeah, you know, just a great call. You run Lauder twice on almost an identical look, then you give him that look one more time. Whitfield did a great job when we saw it on the replay as well. You know, he stuck that ball in there long enough that it just sucked everybody in, and once he's gone, I mean, he, as you said, untouched.
Yeah, absolutely.
You know, 38 yards, great read. Great blocking downfield by the wide receivers as well.
Yeah, the line did a great job, it all started with that play fake. I mean, he really put it in Maddie's gut and rode him all the way through and sucked those linebackers into Southwestern and bid on the play fake, and it was a great start and great, you know, three rushes?
And let's face it, it gets set up by Lauder's two, you know, he bangs
absolutely
in there twice, the line bangs in there twice. Now Southwestern all of a sudden is saying, holy crow, this is going to be a long day. They're going to keep banging away. Next thing you know, there goes Whitfield. Yeah, great job. Great job. But you're right. Now, you know, it's important for the Fredonia players and, more importantly, the Fredonia coaches to keep them level.
Absolutely.
They're high as a kite right now. They're flying. They're up. You know, they just had the huge play. And you're right. History would say, if you know, hopefully the coaches are reminding them of that. History says don't count just because you had a nice start. Don't count Southwestern out.
And they can score a ton of points in a hurry just like the Fredonia team can. So, again, we were talking about over-under. I expect this to be a high-scoring game, so Southwestern is going to get their plays and make their plays as well. Calder near on for the kickoff. Let's see. I expect a similar strategy here as last time. This on the other side of the field, same type of kick, but it's caught in the air right around the 27.
Great
That's
play.
A real nice tackle there by Micah 22. Davis.
Yep. Yeah,
the
that
open
was big.
Field one-on-one.
He
could have
had
some
room.
If he turned that corner, absolutely. Yeah. We're going to see this on replay. So that's not perfect execution there, because you don't want them catching the air, and they were able to and had a chance for a return. So nice tackle there by Davis.
Although that's the guy we want. You know, we don't want their back.
And there he is. That's number 35 of Southwestern on the return, Matt Butterfield, sophomore.
So they are right on the 30, looks like.
Yep. 31 maybe. Yep, 31-yard line. First and 10. Kennedy in. Looks like he's going to shotgun. Two backs in the backfield. Pistol formation going to Walsh here. Tries to hurdle a tackler, but nothing there. Lauder finished it off. That's Devon McCall. Looks like it was the first one there. They tried hurdling McCall, and Lauder's there. And you know, Matt Lauder has been looking forward to this game since last year. You're going to see it in the replay. The outside linebacker stays home, does a nice job stepping up here. And really, most of that tackle does go to McCollum, but Lauder finished him
McCollum
off.
Yeah, McCall made the play. And once again, look at that safety. He is 17, 18 yards deep.
Southwestern loves to hit the deep seam here. McCall's dying. There's a pass right over the middle, completed. And Fry makes the tackle.
Nice hit.
But, yeah, Fry got up, but that was 21. Cameron Link with the catch, the tight end. And he definitely probably won that battle against Fry coming up for safety. So you're going to see a lot of that over the middle and seam passing from Southwestern. And Fredonia's got to find a way to stop it. That's the first down for Fredonia. And, you know, a lot of space there. And you know, Fry stopped him in his tracks too. So that was a nice hit by both players. And it's glad to see both of them get up.
Back in the power eye.
Kennedy under center. Gives it to, play action to Walsh, looking deep. He's got a man, it's completed. McCall makes a tackle, but a nice throw by Kennedy. right back to 21. And that is Cameron Lemke. And what a throw there by Kennedy, Greg.
Great throw. And, again, just what we talked about. Southwestern isn't sitting there with their head down saying, oh, my gosh. You know, they come right back, and now we're on the 23.
Absolutely. So back-to-back first downs for the Trojans, and this place is starting to fill up. I was getting a little worried, wondering where all the fans were. When he got here tonight, and even 10, 15 minutes before the game, it was real light on the spectators. I expect the place to be packed, and it is filling up with more and more people coming in now. First and 10 for the Trojans. Kenny back in shotgun. Hands off to number 4.
He's got a lot of room.
Gets outside there. Breaks a tackle. Finally pushed out of bounds. That's number 1. No, 4. Excuse me. Matt Panis. Yep. So 3 first downs on 3 plays for the Trojans.
And they're in the red zone.
Yeah, containment's given up here. Block the end. Davis gets sucked in there. Nice block by Walsh on him. And there's a lot of running room out there, and breaks another tackle on the other Davis. So Davis didn't do so well in that play, Krause.
Uh-oh. No,
dinner for them tonight.
Yeah, no soup for you. So where are we at? The first 5 or the 4? We'll call it the 4.
Southwestern looking to equalize, and Kennedy is going to keep this one up the middle.
I don't
see any signals. Southwestern signal, but the officials are not, and that's the official. Well, second goal right around the 1.
It'll be second and short.
And official timeout. There is a player down. It's a Trojan down. Was that lineman? I can't see the number here. He's being held off immediately, not putting much weight on his leg at all. So let's see if we can get a number. I still don't have a number, Greg. Sorry.
No, we can't. Yeah, well, he's got those big offensive linemen helping him out. They block out the sun, much less our view. Here we go.
Number four.
That is Panis, who already had several carries and had that big 19-yard gain.
Yeah, so that's Panis. And for the year, Matt Panis has 10 carries for 70 yards offensively, and he has 16 catches offensively. So leading receiver for Southwestern down on that play. So we'll definitely keep an eye on that. That could be a big loss for the Trojans. Kennedy's under center. Walsh the deep back. Kenny's going to keep it, and he gets in for the touchdown.
Kennedy on the keeper for a Trojan touchdown.
And that is Aiden Kennedy's rushing touchdown, number 6 of the season. So, again, Kennedy's a real weapon through the air and on the ground, as we've seen already this so far tonight.
And Fredonia – their drive lasted about a minute. Southwestern uses 2 minutes to come back the other way.
Yeah, so, and we're going to see a lot of
the
points.
Barn burner that you talked about. Yeah, we were talking over-under, and I was, 45, 46. No. You said it's going to be over 50. So,
looks like it's at 81 kicking, Nevis.
Yes.
And his extra point attempt is good as well. 2 solid kickers tonight. And we have a tie ball game, 6:20 in the first quarter. 7-7, Fredonia versus Southwestern. So 2 nice drives.
That went over the bleachers. I mean, that would have been good from 35 yards.
And last week we saw Sal Tabone. You weren't with us in Salamanca. I was on the radio. It was an unsportsmanlike penalty after the touchdown. Sal Tabone made a 35-yard extra point last week and just missed another one. So both kickers are able to make that longer field goal. We'll see if that comes into play at any point tonight.
Pat popped in. We'll have to get him in here for a player perspective from the old days or something. Yeah.
So this is going to be real interesting, folks, here. Southwestern is always looking for an advantage. You know, very, very well-coached team. And they very rarely kick it deep. Most of the time, it's some sort of pooch.
Although, with this kid who we just watched, you know, he just kicked that thing.
But look where Fredonia's defense is expected, or special teams expect them not to kick it deep. The Bronski's the deepest guy at the 20. The Davis boys are at the 30.
In fact, they're loading up for a onside.
Right, because, you know, obviously you do not want to give that up if you're the Fredonia. So it's a real advantage here by the Southwestern Trojans that they're able to do this, and their kicker can put the ball anywhere he wants on the field. We've seen it in years past, and, he's done it so far this year as well. And he's a pooch kick here. High, Davis is able to tip it to himself right around the 25, and he's got room.
He's got room.
And he's still on his feet.
That's Simon Davis, and he is going to go
all the way for a second kickoff touchdown.
70-yard kickoff return.
In back-to-back games, Simon Davis, two huge returns. What a run, and what speed he just showed off there.
Now, the speed in the run was great. The tip was the play.
Yes.
I mean, when he put his hand up and tipped that up, that could have been a disaster or, as we see, just a great, great play. And, boy, what an answer.
Yeah, and it's interesting. Coach Johnson said to me, former neighbor, he was like, Shannon, don't expect Southwestern to kick off to Simon today.
Right.
And they just did, and he made them pay for it. Sal Tabone on the for the extra point. And the kick is up, and he squeaks that in. A little bit more of a line drive kick, but it is good, making the score. Fredonia 14, Southwestern 7. 6:07 still in the first quarter.
We're halfway through the first quarter, and we've got 21 down.
Absolutely.
You know, by the way, from looking at either offense, no sign of it letting up.
No, not at all. You know, Fredonia's defense got to go right back on the field, but on the other side, it was just a few plays they've been on the field so far, so it's not like they should be worn out or tired there at all.
Boy, I know we looked at the – can we do another replay? Can we go back to that one more time real quick? No? All right.
You're asking for quite a bit, Greg.
I know. No. It was wonderful to see the replay, but, boy, what a nice – I mean, he found that gap because there was player. It wasn't he went the sidelines. He went right through the gap. Again – young kids that are watching, north and south.
You know,
get north and south.
And if you
good things happen.
For his kickoff return last week, he went to the right sideline, almost like he was going out of bounds, cut back, and ended up scoring by the left pylon. So it was very different style return there. But, yeah, that was a north sound, hit a hole, and took off and really took advantage of it. Calder near on to kickoff for Fredonia.
So now you've got to imagine that the Fredonia coaches are going to do everything to avoid
give that up the other way. Absolutely.
So we wonder where Calder's going to go with this one.
It's going to be right along the sidelines, I guarantee it, and probably a little lower than last time. Last kick got up a little too high. You don't want to be able to catch it in the air. And it is high, though, and it is going to pin them. And either going to let that go out of bounds. But, again, I know that's part of the strategy. Now, Southwestern can say, nope, kick it again, or they can take it at the 35. So let's see what they do. Looks like the offense is coming out on the field for Southwestern, so they're going to take it at the 35. And you know what? Fredonia is more than fine with that. I know that's part of their strategy.
Here's kick goes out of bounds. It'll be Trojan ball at the 35.
So what does Southwestern do here? Keep their cool, come out, you know, run the same type
of
play
call. Do what they just did.
Yeah, absolutely.
I mean, it was a wonderful mix of runs and passes.
Yeah.
They threw a short pass to get it going. They threw a longer pass. They threw a little swing pass. So, you know, I think it's they're going to come out and do what they do, right?
Absolutely. And Aiden Kennedy, I watched him play CSP last year. And he does not get shaken. He got the crap beat out of him against CSP, and he single-handedly won that game for the Trojans in the section semifinal.
Got some motion. Fredonia's obviously zone.
Option play. McCall is there, and McCall in. Lauder comes in to help clean that up. Great job by the defense there. And that starts with the defensive end doing his job.
Second and
taking the quarterback. We saw Alex Palouk bit on a fake pitch a couple times last week. He did not. He went right after the quarterback, forced the pitch. The outside linebacker McCall was there, and Lauder was there to help clean it up. Great three-man defense right there. No gain or maybe one on the play.
Very tight formation for Southwestern.
Yeah, you got a bunch here to the left. Is that going to be a false start?
All sorts
of flags here.
Yeah, I think 57 flinched.
It is. All right, false start. Is that our first penalty?
First penalty of the game.
You weren't with us last week. 34 penalties in the first half alone. Yeah. It was like if you got two plays off in a row last week, you felt accomplished. So first penalty here for tonight. And knock on wood, one of Fredonia's Achilles heels are the unsportsmanlike conduct plays. They haven't got one yet, and that's the longest I think they've made in a game without getting one so far.
So now it's a good 14, you know, second and 14, changes to a spread offense.
Kennedy's in the backfield, one back to his left, trips left, looking left, back, a lot of time, deep
well
throw.
Covered.
Davis is there deflecting it, and we called that earlier. You know, they're going to attack Davis. He gave up a couple big passes last week, but Simon Davis was there and knocked that one away, third and 14.
Yeah, that was just a straight. I mean, I happened to look out because just watching that player, there wasn't a move, a shake. That was just a straight run, but he had all sorts of time.
Absolutely. No pass rush there. Good coverage downfield. Davis went up and got that, knocked that down. It was intended to number four. That might have been Panis is back. So it's a good sign for the Trojans. He's lining up wide one-on-one here against Davis again.
Oh, there he is. Yeah, I was going to say.
Yeah. Kennedy is under center here, which is interesting. Third and 14. Motion to the left. He's faking it to Walsh, rolling to his right. He's under pressure.
Good coverage.
And Lauder's there, knocks that away. Nothing there. Looking for 21, who has two catches already. That's Cameron Lame, third and 14.
Yeah, great coverage. Great cut. Here we go. We got it on the screen. And, again, I'm not sure why they had him under center, but lots of time, had a good look.
Is that Owen Rush? Who's getting defensive lineman there? Because Palouk took that hard in and gave Kennedy the corner. But good job by the defensive lineman there. I think that was Owen Rush not letting Kennedy turn the corner to run and forcing this punt. Kennedy's back. Another line drive punt. Big hop. And
let it go now.
Fry can't get it. It's going to go right around the 26-yard line for Fredonia. Really their second offensive possession of the game. They didn't even get the ball the second time on the kickoff. There is a flag, though.
At the 26-yard line, Fredonia first down.
Or is that just on our screen? Is there a flag, or we just have a mistake? No, way back by the punter, there's a flag.
Did he get
rubbed? I didn't see that. Yeah, I don't know.
I mean, that was
Is that too far to go back and look at that again,
24.
Chip?
That's a 53-yard punt.
Yeah, you got a nice line drive. And the officials are talking about this. So if it is, you're hoping it's just not, what is it? There's roughing and there's a 5 and a 15 is what I'm trying to get at. You don't want the 15.
But I didn't see anybody. I guess that's.
Oh, wow. It is. What a mistake. There's that big penalty for Fredonia.
And if you don't see it. Then it's usually the latter. It's usually the roughing because if we would have seen it, but, boy, I'd love to go back. I was watching that kick, turned my head, so it had to be really. Coach Sherlock isn't too happy.
No, and you know, again, for – we didn't see. So, you know, Fredonia coaches don't like it. We're getting told that that wasn't a penalty, but, you know – Kennedy, being the heads-up player there, grabbed – apparently, we can't see it, no confirmation here, but grabbed the guy and fell backwards, and the officials, if that's true, we don't know. That's one-sided perspective. But that's a huge penalty against Fredonia. They would have had the ball back looking to go up two scores, and now Southwestern gets a fresh first down
on
4th and 14.
Yeah.
And that's been Achilles' heel of Fredonia all season long. Is the penalties. Whitfield is lone right here playing cornerback tonight. The last two games started at corner. Kennedy looking at Whitfield. back to his left, looks short, and there's Davis right away. Micah Davis making the tackle. Pass completed to Matt Panties.
Second and eight.
So good job by Davis coming, making that tackle in open field, not giving Panties any running room. Second and eight.
Very tough. I mean, boy, oh boy, Fredonia is being asked to stop a very explosive offense twice.
Trips right here. Two safety high, McCall and Fry back. Kennedy's looking to his left again. He completes it to Panties, and he's going to have a first down. Easy first down completion really there. And Southwestern is now in Fredonia territory after getting a possible break on that punt. Either way, they got a break, whether it should have been a penalty or not.
Right.
You know, they had no business getting that first down. And now you fear the Trojans, you got to take advantage of that. It's Micah Davis in on the tackle, but not before Panties gets a first down. So we're going to look at that matchup all day. Out there, Panties to the left. Kenny's going to keep this one. He's got room up the middle. Looks like gain about five or six. I think that was Micah Davis again in on the tackle, but a good first down play for the Trojans. Gain of six. Now it's second and four. A lot of option. Ball spotted at the Hillbilly 30-yard line. So this Fredonia line, offensively, defensively, the size advantage, they have to win the line of scrimmage today. There's no excuses not to. They sub in all sorts of people. They have to do his trips right. Panties in the motion to the left. Kenny's going to keep it again, and he's going to look to bounce it outside. Nothing out there, and he is cleaned up there. That is Sam Azrock coming from the backside. So that's a backside defensive end coming down that line of scrimmage. So that's a great play there by the sophomore Azra, but you got to be careful there. You know, the Southwestern Trojan coaches see that, and they're going to look for some sort of counter run the other way play, but Azra did a nice job filling behind the line of scrimmage, giving Kennedy no chance to cut back. Third and four, definitely two down territory, ball at the 30. Tight end to – no tight end here. Twins left. Kennedy looking left. Throwing.
Oh, he's got it.
Oh, Davis dropped a sure touchdown the other way. He jumped that route to Panties, and he couldn't hold on.
Great
read by Simon Davis there, knocking that way, because he would have been gone for
Here's
a second
the replay.
Touchdown.
Yeah,
yeah.
That was just a jump. You saw that a mile away. So now it's got to be four down territory, I would say,
absolutely.
The side of the ball, the way they punted especially.
And he's going, he's reading that all
right
the
there.
Way, and just,
oh boy,
he was smelling his second touchdown and holding his head like, oh, I blew an opportunity there. But great read by Davis. Now, again, they can do reverse the backside, pump and go against Davis.
They're
when
in
you
the
get
pistol.
A receiver running those type of routes. Walsh and Panties out left. Yep. Kennedy under center this time, and he is going to fake the handoff.
Oh, he's in
Micah
trouble.
Davis hits him as his throat and falls incomplete. No good, and a turnover on downs. What a stand by the Fredonia Hillbillies there.
That was a, tremendous call to blitz there and came in clean. Here we're going to see the replay. You see him sneaking in.
Coming off his outside linebacker.
Didn't get touched.
Yeah, 68 had two blocks, right. and Kennedy had no choice but to throw that away. Good, clean hit.
Well, he had a man open.
Yeah,
almost.
He did. That's Walsh there. It was in the slot. So either way, that's a great job by the Fredonia defense first getting two Fredonia stops in that position against a powerhouse offense like Southwestern.
So they'll take over at the 30-yard line. First
by
and 10.
By the way, Whitfield doesn't have a pass attempt yet tonight.
It's only their second possession. I mean, right? They had the TD return.
Yeah. Lotter on the carry. Lotter running hard. Again, he is not going to go down easy tonight, folks. He is geared up for this game. He has been for 6 months.
It'll be second down.
Gain of 4 to 5 yards, second down and a long, what do you say, about five. Yeah, yeah, second down, five. About five. Yeah, he's at the 35, got to get to the 40.
You know, it's been such a breakneck. One of the things I was going to talk about, a game like this, turnover, a key turnover, and we just saw almost a key turnover.
You got Fry all alone down here. Right, it's going to be Whitfield on the carry. He's got room to the outside.
First down.
It's going to be first down and more. Goes out of bounds just into Trojan territory.
Whitfield on the kicker for a Hillbilly first down.
So, again, no passing yards yet today for Fredonia, but you know what? The running game is working.
Yeah, I don't blame. I mean, yeah. That was another good cut. They're giving the edge up. They're so loaded up for Lauder.
Nice block there by Sean Farnham there, sealing that edge. And Whitfield really went out untouched. He went out of bounds, you know, nowhere to go here, but he went untouched there again. Lauder to Whitfield's right, and it goes to Lauder, and he gets the carry, and he's going to get to about the 44-yard line. So gain of 5 again on first down, and that just gives you so many options as offensive coordinator.
Just going to say, yeah, you know, that it certainly when he's banging in the middle for 5 yards, that's what opens it up for Whitfield around the edge.
Absolutely. And how do you stop that? You got
look at the left side.
Both guys over 200 pounds.
I was going to say, on the left side of that line, compare, you know, Southwestern's got to be giving up 40 pounds a man.
Yeah, Rush and Farnham done a great job all year. Right back to Lauder this time, and he gets hit in the backfield, but he's still able to get yards. That's a real nice job there. Let's see if I can get a number. I think that's 68, and I had him circled early on. Dante, who's a senior defensive lineman, listed at 6 foot 240. And who's for the season? Let me see if I can get his tackling stats here. But he had a number of tackles for that defensive line spot. I'll get back to that. Sorry. Oh, no, here it is. 21 tackles from the defensive line so far this year. So that'll bring us to the end of the first quarter with the score. Fredonia 14, Southwestern 7. And this has been everything.
Hey, we haven't had any points in the last 6 minutes.
Yeah, I know. What's going on?
But yes.
Yeah. You blamed Simon Davis for that, dropping that interception.
That's right. Teams are hitting. Teams are, you know, both teams are playing. Looking sharp. I mean, the one thing that the takeaway out of that first quarter is that neither team is going to be out of this game. Until deep into the fourth. I mean, either team can score in a hurry. So if we see something happen, somebody gets ahead, somebody gets behind.
All right, Dave Katch just won the Fredonia booster. I think that needs to have a redraw here. I don't think that was accurate, Mr. Lauer.
I thought you just said he owes you money.
Yeah, you're right. Yeah. He does owe. Dave, I'll just keep that for travel baseball fees, all right? I'll just keep the money, all right? Congratulations.
I get to hold it for a little
while. Yeah, just a little while. How fast does that go to his wife's hands as he walks back next to her? So either way, what a first quarter.
Yes.
I mean, again, we've been excited for this game for weeks, all day long. I've been on edge, and it's been everything we thought it'd be so far, and we still have three quarters to play. It's anyone's ball game, and Fredonia really would love to take a two-score lead here. But that is nowhere near enough, even if they do.
Correct. I mean, Kennedy's shown with, you know, they throw the ball well, they can move the ball well. You know, yeah, we're in for a whole game.
Without a doubt. And both teams, you know, they can score any way, defensively, special teams, and especially offensively.
So it's a long 4, a short 5, and here goes Whitfield.
And still no, another first down. He's got the edge. Kennedy to beat. Kennedy tackles him out of bounds, but 3 carries for Whitfield, 3 first downs.
Yeah, he's having his way. I mean, they are so, you know, we talked about it. What do you stop? Do you stop the run? Do you stop the pass? Do you stop inside? Do you stop outside? How do you play that? It looks like Southwestern is really committed to stopping, you know, that inside running game of Fredonia.
Well, or the pass, because they're, I mean, Fredonia has attempted a pass, and, you know.
It's just opened it up for Whitfield to go.
Is there a flag? Looks like Fredonia is walking back here. That would be another. There is a flag down, Greg. And again, Achilles heel of Fredonia. Untimely penalties, and it is against Fredonia. Downfield holding. It'll be from the spot of the foul. So that was past the line of scrimmage where the holding occurred. So it'll still be a gain of about 2 on the play, but it'll remain third down for Fredonia. Looks like they're spotting it right at the 39.
I'm calling it. Oh, there they go. Yep. Yeah, there's the 2.
They marched it back already. So
okay.
So third and short. So, again, second big penalty.
Is that a plus 2 holding penalty? I mean,
it's a rush. It's a 2-yard rush for Whitfield, I believe, so that would go in the stat book. But, again, that was costly. You know, they don't get the first down here. Whitfield's back in shotgun.
Well, wait a second. How do they get the yards?
Because it's from the spot of the foul.
I guess you're right.
Yep.
You're right.
You can see him march it back. The penalty was downfield. Whitfield's going to keep it again. Looking to go to the right. He's got pressure here. He can't turn the corner. He's got another
flag
late here from the back judge. So let's see. Whitfield got about a yard. No, he got out to the 40. What's the penalty here? So here's.
They're talking to Southwestern.
Another holding on Fredonia.
Oh, boy.
And we've talked about this all season. Sooner or later, this is going to hurt them. Back-to-back big penalties. And let's see what Southwestern does. They want 4th and 1, or they want 3rd and long? I'd say
they're
3rd and long.
Yeah, they're going to take it back.
And they are. So it was from the holding must have happened right around the 41 because they're spotting it back. Well, even the 42,
48.
Ball's going, 38, back to the 48 of Fredonia. And Coach Sherlock wants an explanation, but he's seen well too many yellow hankies on the field against his team this year, and they can't continue this trend. So we may see the first pass attempt of Fredonia the game with 11:46 in the second quarter. You got trips to left. Empty backfield here for Whitfield. We'll see if Southwestern brings the house here with an empty backfield.
4-man rush. It doesn't look like anybody's cheating up.
No, that outside
pretty much a man.
A little fake. Let's see.
Boy,
no blitz. Yep, 4-man rush. Whitfield's going to have lots of time looking deep.
He got him. Oh!
A little miscommunication. The receiver is going out. Whitfield threw it to him in.
Hey, he adjusted. He just couldn't quite get to it.
And that's going to bring on the punt team. So, again,
punt
penalties.
From the 48, huh?
Okay. Well, yeah.
It is a field position game.
But those penalties, they had a first down. Or would have been 4th and 1, you know. Had a first down and 3rd down penalty. Had 4th and 1 penalty, making it 3rd and long. And Owen Rush is on to punt for Fredonia. And keep an eye on that. I'm telling you. If anything's going to cost them the game, I guess would be penalties. There's a holding on the outside there. Owen Rush, a high towering punt. I don't see a flag, but Owen Rush, a bounce.
Nice roll.
Right around. It's going to be down right around the 10, 11 yard line.
38-yard net. They'll take it.
Yeah. I mean, he a little higher without the distance, but he got the roll. Owen Rush has been a real weapon the last 2 years on special teams, punting the ball for Fredonia. So now that defense needs another big stop. The offense couldn't take advantage going up by 2 scores. Southwestern's going to look to tie it, 11-12 remaining in the second quarter. Greg's scrambling away here at these stats, trying to keep them down. I know.
These guys are
moving. It's not easy. And keep an eye on this matchup. You got Simon Davis out wide, one-on-one against leading receiver Matt Pinn. All by himself here. No safety help. We'll see if they take a shot. Kennedy under center. Hands it off to Walsh. Walsh tries to bounce the outside. Breaks 1 tackle.
Nothing.
Can't break the second. Is that Devon McCall maybe out there? It is. Devon McCall for the tackle for the loss.
Stop by Devon McCall. It'll be 2nd and 12.
Good job there. Outside containment by Ezra and McCall. No, sorry. That's Alex Paluk over on the left side. Ezra and Micah Davis on the right side. Good defense there. Second and about 12. Ball's going to be spotted right around Southwestern's own 9-yard line. Two deep safeties now, expecting pass. Kennedy in the shotgun. And he is going to drop the pass. Now he's scrambling. And he's got nowhere to go. And Kennedy is going down for the sack for third and long. Great job by the sophomore, San Ezra, not letting Kennedy get outside. And I think he might have got a half a sack here, but that all started with Ezra, as you're going to see on the replay. You know, and that's Kennedy's game. You got to keep him in that pocket and not let him break out. Ezra does that. He gets rushed. Here he is, steps up. He's able to keep him in just barely. And there is, who is that, number 50 of Fredonia. That's Jaden Whitfield cleaning up, getting the big sack, loss of about 3. So we got third and 15 here. Ball spotted right around maybe the 5-6 yard line.
I expect him to run the ball and
Nope. Kennedy's dropping back to pass. He's under pressure again. Rolling deep. And this time he throws it short and he found him. What a job by Kennedy.
Yep.
Buying some extra time, finding number one, Jason Knee, and a big Southwestern first down there. And that was all Kennedy buying extra time.
Yeah, I'm trying to find that number. Yeah, it was Connor. Sean Farnham. Sean Farnham, the big Sean Farnham. He had him penned, but he knew enough not to go. I'm going to just hang in here and let my friends come.
Yeah.
That's all the time that Kennedy needed.
And you hear the coaches up here, you know, why didn't we blitz on that play? Hand off here to number 4, Panties, and he's hit hard in the backfield. That's Micah Davis, and let's see who else was in on the tackle. Davis and Cash, I believe. Gain of about 1, second down and 9.
Second and 10.
So, you know, minus some big penalties and a couple, you know, well, really, 3 real big penalties against Fredonia so far is keeping Southwestern in this game. And that one big play on third down to get that first down really has been the difference so far. Kennedy back in shotgun. Walsh is to his left. And Kennedy is dropping back to pass again, looking to his right, and receiver is dropped. Whitfield on the cover there, but that ball is a little low, but that was dropped right off the chest of his intended receiver, and that would have been enough for a first down. That was Ashton Matthews, I believe, for Southwestern was the intended receiver.
So another he was sitting down. Catch that ball, you got your first down.
Right, right.
I'm a little nervous. Whitfield gave that little hit at the end. Player was already giving himself up on his knees. Those are the kind of things that'll get you that extra 15
yards. Yeah, that would be a tough one to call, but you're right, especially with Fredonia's reputation.
He's already on his knees.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? He can't get up and go. You know, I'm with you. It would have been a tough call.
Absolutely.
But you're right.
No, I mean, and again, when you get the reputation of being that team, you're not going to get the benefit of the doubt. So we got a bunch here to the left. Kennedy. Walsh to his left. Kennedy is looking now.
Walsh standing to block.
Trying to direct traffic, and Davis on the coverage, and Kennedy can't find him. It's going to force. It's Micah Davis this time.
Yep.
Yeah, you think you're going to force. And now we got a Fredonia player down.
Pass ball's incomplete. It'll bring up fourth down.
And that's Alex Palouk, and that'd be a big loss. He's coming off limping on his own, so hopefully he can return because he's been an out. You know, Connolly Cup or Trench Trophy nominee last week. For his game in Salamanca at defensive end with a couple sacks. So we'll keep an eye on that. But Kennedy is on to punt here. Fry is the lone return man. So again, Fredonia does not trust Southwestern here, looking for fake all the way. And Kennedy has those long low-line drive punts that really are hard to return anyway. And this is a little deeper. Fry's going to have a chance now. He's back, catching right around the 26-yard line. Cuts it up, but good coverage by Southwestern, and really no blocking. They're looking to stop the fake and so on. So Fredonia is going to get their third chance now to take a 2-score lead, and they really need to take advantage of that and have a nice drive here.
So they're going to get it on the 38. $7.59.
14-7, as you can see. Second quarter here. Big possession here in the game for Fredonia. They really need to get a drive going and get a chance.
Just haven't had really many possessions.
No.
Between the, yeah.
Hand off to Lotta right out the middle. Nice hole. Untouched. First down. Gain of about 14, 15 yards. Off to the right side. Good job there. You got Izzy Martinez and Matt Cash, Simon Price at center, doing a great job creating that hole for the senior running back, Matt Cash. Still no pass attempt here, right?
Correct.
And who would have guessed that? Right back to Lotter again, another big hole to the right side, rumbling some, another first down, or darn close to it. Let's look at the spot.
I think they're going to be just short. Uh-oh, that's a flag out there. There's a flag way back, way out. Are they going to call a formation penalty? That's my guess from where he's standing.
That, or there was someone mixed up. Obviously, we weren't looking out that side. I mean, that's nothing to do with the play. Fredonia's calling themselves back, and here's that Achilles heel again. Another big penalty. It looks like the way Fredonia's reacting.
I mean, this can't. I mean, what are the officials talking? I mean, it's a pretty easy. If you're going to drop the flag, you better know what what you got. Oh, they're picking it up. Looks like they're picking it up. All right. Hey. Perhaps it was a formation issue. They decided, are they going to, so let's see, we got, are they going to call it a first down now? That's the next question. Nope, second down. Second down, just inches. Now, hey, perhaps we'll see that first pass. That is the, you know, the opportunity. Although I wouldn't blame Coach Sherlock. I mean, they are just grinding it. You know, controlling the offensive line. They're got to be averaging at least 8 or 10 yards a carry. It is awful tempting when you're in this field position to take that shot when you got a second and that short. Whitfield in the pistol, trips left. Whitfield's gonna just get the first, keep it moving, keep those chains moving. So he gets it to the 34. And that'll bring us another first down. Whitfield. And that's about the first time we see Lotter on the read option. That's about the first time that they've made that stop. So gain of 2-4. Matt Lotter. Down to the 32. Second and 8. Fredonia in a double wide. Little bubble screen, got some room. And that'll be Brandon Ronsky with his first catch and our first completion of the game for Fredonia.
Gain of 11 and a first down.
And we are now on a first down at the 22. Trips left. Simon Davis alone on the right side. And there's our second throw. Very nice. Went right back to Ronsky. Nice quick hitter for a gain of eight. Nine. We're going to call that nine. You missed the first two completions.
Second down, one here. Right back to Lotter, right out the middle. It's going to be a first down and more. Battling for yardage here. Lotter's not going down easy all the game long.
And what a nice call. You know, we throw a couple of balls. All of a sudden, Southwestern's, you know, got to be thinking, well, maybe there. Here comes that Fredonia air attack. And go right back to pounding away with Lotter in the red zone. First and goal at the five.
Looks like we got Trips right here. Gives the Lotter out the middle. Nothing there that time. Number 70, Southwestern. That's Kenyon Davidson on the big tackle.
Second and goal.
Lotter's coming off a little limping here a little bit. Micah Davis is coming in. It's the last thing Fredonia wants to see right now.
Although, it's got to be just something, stinger. He's a tough kid, and it's just
he'll be back in on his own
power. So may alter, maybe we'll see that pass now. There we go.
The call is incomplete. I don't know if he would have got in, but he went down right about the one, I think, if he makes that catch. So now it's going to be third and goal.
Goodfield's pass ball is incomplete.
Yeah, good call, good pass. Just got to execute. Now you start thinking, do you kick a field goal? It's third and five.
If
you're still at third and five,
right, I mean,
do you think about that?
A little bit longer, an extra
score
point. Yeah.
Right, it's barely more than an extra point, and Tabone's had plenty of leg.
Davis is to Whitfield's left. Whitfield, he gives it to Davis. He breaks one, but he's tackled right around the 1 yard line, maybe the two. It's going to be fourth and goal now, and what do you do here?
Micah Davis with the gain of six. It'll be fourth and two.
Looks like Whitfield's at least going to fake underneath the center. Let's see. They do this a lot. Little fake. He's going to keep it.
He bounced it in.
Bounced it to the outside, and he is in for a second rushing touchdown today.
Yes.
Nick Whitfield, and what a drive by Fredonia, converting on fourth and goal.
Really nice. I mean, just mixed the pass, mixed the run, steady plays. All started right out at the beginning with a big Lotter run, but ends up, with that. 4 minutes to go. Nice 4 minute drive. Keep Southwestern off the field.
And going up 21-7. Now, this is really big. If Fredonia can stop Southwestern from scoring here to end the first half, Fredonia gets the ball to start.
Correct.
The second. Now, there's still 4 minutes left. A lot of things can happen, but that's something that's Tabone on for the extra point. And the kick is good. And that definitely would have been good for that field goal attempt you were talking about.
21, Southwestern 7.
But that's a real big touchdown for the Fredonia Hillbillies. Great drive, mixing the first couple pass attempts. I think Whitfield's like 2 for 3 on that drive. Two completions to Ronsky. And ultimately running it in himself and all along that left side of the line. Good job there by Farnham and Rush, getting that push so Whitfield could bounce to the outside and get the touchdown.
Yeah, this is a big 4 minutes now for, you know, Fredonia to control. If they can keep Southwestern out of the end zone,
yeah,
coming out with the ball in the third quarter, being able to make adjustments and things like that, just a huge opportunity for them.
Yeah,
of course, after, Southwestern's thinking just the opposite. Southwestern's saying, hey,
well, let's go score.
4 minutes. We've scored in less than that, easy.
All
let's get
years.
Ourselves down there. We get ourselves in, and we're down one score going into the half. So, you know, both teams, as we've said, both teams are capable of scoring quick. Even that was like a ball control drive.
Yes, it was.
And it was only a four-minute drive. And I say only in that we see plenty of 7-, 8-, 9-minute drives in high school games. You know, they covered 62 yards in 4 minutes.
Yeah. So Calder near on to kickoff again. You know, I would look for a similar high kick. You know, Southwestern's expecting it now. So if you could get one by their back guy, just like we talked about with Fredonia, they tried to with Simon Davis, who came up with it. But let's see what they do, if they call it that same style kickoff or they do a low-line drive trying to get between these guys. They're going
little pooch.
A little lower pooch kick, bounces.
Stays in. Oh!
Oh, and he knocked it out of bounds himself.
Yeah.
Smart play there. Perfect kick, really. Ball's going to be spotted right around the 28. No chance for return. Didn't go out of bounds on his own.
Perfect kick. You know, took the bounce. It almost settled like that first kick did. And number one for Southwestern, who we don't have in our program.
Number one for Jason Nye.
Jason Nye, not Jackie.
No, Jackie's a brother. There's
all
a
right.
Jason. Yep, and Jason's a senior running back linebacker.
So Jason kind of smart play, didn't have much else to do.
Yeah.
He could have tried to pick it up and carry it, but that's
if
how
you fumble
the ball.
Yeah,
right.
Absolutely.
Right.
And for that pressure, you know, if Fredonia recovers, that'd be a backbreaker. So now, Fredonia, the last thing they want to do here is give up a big play. The Southwestern scores, make them earn it, make them drive, you know, the field here. You know, 72 yards. Let's see if they do it. Kennedy's back to pass.
Play
little
action.
Pump and
looking
go. Good decent covers there, Davis. We talked about that earlier. Davis jumped that route. You knew at some point they were going to go to that because he's hanging low. And, you know, he may have been beat by half a yard, but would have taken absolute perfect pass by Kennedy.
Well, and to your point, before that play went off, Fry was there. In the, here, as you watch, even as he's diving, that he had a lot of safety help. You know,
he did.
If he catches that ball, he's not. It's not like he's behind the whole defense.
Right.
So,
I
that
like
may
the play
also
call.
Be why
yeah.
Davis is there. Yeah.
You know, and maybe that'll back Davis a little bit, give him something to think about anyway. And in that matchup again, we've seen him go that way a lot. Completed a couple. Davis almost had the pick six. Good coverage there. So it's a real battle. And we talked about that early. That's a real key.
And this is their guy.
This is their leading receiver.
He seems to be the, you know, I mean, Kennedy comes out of there looking for him.
Yeah, Kennedy gives it to Walsh this time. Breaks one tackle, but that is, I believe, Alex Paluk.
There we go.
I think hockey years, I've known Alex and the Paluk family for years, and my kids yell at me all the time, Dad, it's Paluk, and I always say Paluk, but it's nice to see Paluk back on the field.
Yeah.
And that's a big tackle on third down. Good D staying home. Another third and long situation for Southwestern. And here's that one-on-one coverage we talked about right in front of us here. Kennedy's got back to each side. One
Fry's
receiver
gonna roll
right,
this way a little
and
bit.
He's looking this way, and it is completed. Davis
hang
is
on.
Gonna hang on. Fry comes up big hit, but it's gonna be enough for a first down. And
clock
that's a
keeps
battle.
Moving.
Yep.
Will they call the timeout? No, did they?
No,
call
it's it? Gonna stop it until the
on
chain
the first
is,
down.
Yeah, yep. Right about the 40. Oh, they gave him the 46. So good play there. Clock should be running now, and it is. It's gonna be under 3 minutes now. A little too much cushion, but a nice job there by Davis hanging on just enough with one handed on his jersey, and Fry comes up and helps finish him off.
I'll tell you, one of the adjustments I'm making at halftime is I'm doubling number four everywhere he goes.
Or you put Witt out here on him.
Yeah.
Kennedy keeps it this time. Tackle is made there by, let's see, that's Sam Azra, the sophomore.
Gain of seven.
Let's see. It's going to be a gain. Where are they spotting that? It's going to be a gain of a long five right around the 49-yard line. Needs to get to the 44. Just, you know, not quite to the 44. So close to 6 yards on first down by Kennedy. And they need this drive here. Again, down by. And we got a little switch. They put McCall out here on four. And Davis is going up to. And they're looking that way. Nothing. Kennedy's rolling to his right now.
The good job. Keep him. Oh, he's got
and that's
room.
What Kennedy will do. Breaks another tackle. Is going to get a first down and get out of bounds. And again, good defense by Fredonia. And Paluk is still limping there a little bit. But that's all Kennedy there. Good coverage downfield. You got the pass pressure. You kept him contained for a while there. Might have been a little bit of hold.
First down, Southwestern.
Well, I know, I'm sure the Fredonia coaches would like to see a hold after all the calls that have gone against them.
Right.
But once again, I don't think it affected it.
No, so Paul Kennedy got to the 40 of the Hillbillies. It's going to be first and 10. 1:46 remaining in the half. Southwestern down two scores. Timeout, Southwestern. That's interesting with a stop clock there.
Not a stop clock, right?
Yeah, it was. He went out of bounds. Kennedy ran out of bounds for the first down. So the clock's going to stop
and
not start
until
the snap. No.
So we're under two. They've got two timeouts left.
You know, and you hate to say this because Paluk has been such a strong, but he is really limping out there, Greg. And you don't want to take him out as your coaching staff, but really he's no match for Kennedy right now with a bum leg. You know, maybe you might put in a Mendez or someone fresh to get that pass rush on here. But that shows how much faith they have in Paluk and how well he's played all year long for the Hillbillies.
So now, let's see. A minute 46. They don't really need to do any, with two timeouts, they don't really need to do anything special.
No, they got lots of time to score. And Southwestern's used to this situation. I mean, not used to being down two scores, but they're used to scoring with a minute 50 on the clock is what I'm getting at.
Right.
That does not intimidate them at all. And so Devon McCall is staying at corner here. Davis going to the second safety.
We don't have we don't have that deep safety that we've had.
No.
I don't know if Kennedy's going to see that.
Davis is up.
It looks like they're bringing the blitz.
Nope. Micah Davis coming off the right side, but he's picked
up. He's looking for it.
He's going deep against Simon Davis, and he knocks it away. That's a great coverage down the field by number one, and they're still targeting him, but he was equal to the task there.
Great coverage. I was a little nervous he didn't turn his head, but again, it's a different ruling in high school compared, you know. But
and he didn't, it wasn't a ton of body. We're going to see it on replay here. He didn't plow into him, but they're looking for a great job on the blitz pickup there. And again, that one-on-one coverage. You know, that's a good no call. I know I'm a little biased, Dad, but I'm more critical of my son than anyone.
And it was short. I mean, it was the receiver actually came back. If there was initiated contact, it was from the receiver. So now we got a minute 39.
Second and 10, ball at the 40. Kennedy's running to the left, designed run, and he breaks loose. Almost broke that. There's a late flag there.
They're going to call a late hit. You watch.
Sam Azrott made the tackle.
I didn't see
the late hit.
He flopped on him, but it wasn't. I think it's a horrid call.
And they are pointing towards Fredonia.
Watch. You're going to see it now. We're going to watch and see. If you're going to let him.
But
it was shoulder.
You know what? Right, and, with all the hype for the game, they know Lauder wants to hit Kennedy. He does that, and that's cost his team. That's an undisciplined penalty. There's no reason for that hit. I don't know if I have a problem with that call. You got to be smarter than that, especially in this situation. 1:30 up two scores. The last thing you want to do is help them down the field with a penalty like that. Ball's going to be spotted. I don't know if they have the 20. I guess the tip might be right at the 20. Clock is running here. but plenty of time. I believe Southwestern has two timeouts left. Kennedy in shotgun. Kennedy drops back to throw, looking to his right. Now
he's
running.
He's got lots of room.
Oh, big hit over there by the corner.
Down to the eight, though.
Yep, it's going to be first and goal. Clock stop.
Kennedy picks up the first down.
I didn't see who made that tackle. That might be Whitfield out there playing that corner position. I think he's going to come up and stick Kennedy. Quarterback on quarterback
here
Greg.
Go.
Yeah. Yep. Lifts him right up off the ground and plants him. And there's a rivalry between those two. You know, Nick Whitfield's gotten a Division I offer. Kennedy's looking for it. He didn't get one. There was even some controversy. Kennedy calling Long Island University. Why didn't I get the offer? I've beaten him multiple times. So there's definitely some hard feelings there. Both two great quarterbacks. Don't get me wrong. So first and goal, 106. Fredonia up two scores, 21-7. This is a big possession for Southwestern. Looking to get back within one. Kenny's going to keep it again. Nothing there that time. So it's going to make it second goal. The clock's running now. It's going to be down. You know, time they take the snap. And you almost wondered if, you know, does Fredonia take a timeout here to maybe have some time left. But
I think you're up to, you don't want to give them the chance to regroup and set a call. And
yeah, and they're really huddled up. It's going to be under 30 seconds.
Right.
So, you know, this is going to be the last possession one way or the other. Second goal from the five, 23 seconds. Kennedy back to pass, rolling to his left. Still scrambling now. He's hit as he's thrown, incomplete. Back to his right with 15 seconds left. Sam Hazra hit Kennedy as he throw. Great coverage downfield, though.
Yes.
Kennedy had a lot of time and could not find a receiver.
Well, and you can see that the Fredonia defensive line has been told, you know, that they respect Kennedy's running ability.
Absolutely.
Instead of coming hog wild, they're breaking down. They're keeping him in the backfield. They'd rather see him run than throw.
Well, they'd rather see him in the pocket than outside.
That's
the
what
pocket.
I mean. They'd rather see him throw than run. So they're keeping him in there. Now there's the timeout.
And you know, we saw in the replay, it would have. Now, Kennedy couldn't get much on that throw because he got hit by Ezra.
Yeah.
But that was attended for 21 out there, Cameron Link. And there might have been some room there. Now, he was back around the 10, but there
coming
was a lot
halftime.
Of space.
All right, so we've got, let's see.
Third and goal from the five.
We've got Coach Sherlock. He's got a question. He's asking why, what. I'm trying to figure out what he is questioning at this point. They're looking for, maybe he's looking for him to be called down.
I don't know. It's hard to say. Maybe we can try to find out at halftime what Coach Sherlock is talking to him there. I don't think there's any way he was down on that play. And I think it was definitely forward. Maybe his question if that was a forward pass or a fumble.
Oh, that's a good point.
But I think it was definitely forward. I think the officials got that right. But it's hard to say. Or could have been something from three plays ago.
Right.
Holding that they wanted to. Now timeout Fredonia.
They wanted us to take a look.
Yeah. No, and you think they might have waited a half a second more to see if there's going to be motion or anything else, but you don't want to get caught if you're not ready. And, again, why take them? You can't carry them over the second half. So
No
problem with that. It's a good call by the Fredonia coaching staff. And what a goal line stance, two plays we have here. You know, Southwestern scores, they're right back in it, going down by one at halftime. But if Fredonia can stop them and they get the ball to start the second half. So, obviously, you don't have to explain to anyone how big these two plays really are. Now, what do you do, Greg? Do you run? You can run or throw, right, if you're Southwestern?
Yes, you've got a timeout.
They have a timeout left. You know, you would think if they did run, it's probably Kennedy running, right?
So what if they – so now, you know, think ahead. Do you – if you run and – if you don't gain any yards on this play, do you consider a field goal? They got the leg. They need a point.
They still be down by two touchdowns.
I understand.
So I think you go, in my opinion, but hopefully we find out.
Yeah.
Kennedy from the shotgun looking to his left. He has a receiver, incomplete.
There was some bumping good going on, but there's going to
there.
Be no call. Yep, which is a good no call.
Yeah.
Incomplete brings up fourth down.
So here we go. And you know what? There's some subs coming in, Greg, so you might be right. And I don't know. I think if you're Fredonia, you're a little relieved they're going to go for a field.
Well,
that Kennedy just went off the field.
Yeah, if Kennedy's off the field, they're kicking the field goal.
Yeah. So, again, you're still down by two
scores. Yeah, 81 is their kicker.
Yeah.
Well, but I'll tell you, you need the point. You want the points. Right. You want something positive out of this right now. You know.
But is this – if they make this field goal, is this a mental blow? Fredonia feels like they win right now if they make the field goal, don't they?
Yes. I don't think that – I think both sides are going to take this away with a positive. Fredonia made the stop.
Don't rough the kicker here for crying out loud. Don't
Or watch for a fake. They're not going to fake it with Kennedy off.
And it's no good.
He missed it, right?
Yeah, no good to the left. So Fredonia with a huge goal line stand with 5 seconds left.
Plenty of leg, but just ripped it left.
So Fredonia's defense, that bend but don't break, was definitely evident there. And they're going to, I would assume they're going to kneel this down way back at their own territory at the end of the half. I don't see how you don't take a kneel down here. You don't want to take – I mean, you could take a shot, but that's really risky. Up by two scores.
Correct.
Getting
just
the ball.
The injury factory.
Right. Or, you know, you turnover, touchdown. Right. That's the last thing you want to give Southwestern right here. Just take the kneel down, in my opinion. Let's see. Looks like Whitfield's going to be under center. Do you do that classic fake kneel down and drop back and throw it deep to one of your receivers? But, no, I think you take the kneel down. Oh, they had a whistle. I thought he might have taken a quick. He did. Did Southwestern take a timeout, though? No.
No, that would be all silly.
Right. Yeah.
Yeah, they're going
to win. And that'll bring us to the end of the first half. You know, and we saw a little bit of everything. You saw defense. You saw special teams. You saw some big passes. And you definitely saw a very strong running game by the Fredonia offense there, and starting with that offensive line. So at the going into the half, it is Fredonia 21, Southwestern 7, and we'll take a
I need a break, but if you want to have a chat,
we can take a little halftime break right now.
Yep.
All right, we'll take a halftime break. We'll calculate the stats. We might have a special guest coming in to help us do the halftime show, and we'll be back to you in about 8 minutes.
Yeah.
About 8 minutes, we'll be back.
All right, so we're back with about 4 minutes before the half starts, and we have a special guest today. Pat Mahaney's in with us. Pat was a quarterback. We're trying to figure out, probably not the last time, but You had a big rivalry game against Southwestern. You were playing quarterback. Tell us about it.
Oh, yeah, big-time rivalry. Southwestern was – Fredonia always was the one that I was looking real forward to. We always didn't like playing each other, and it was always a battle. We ended up beating them here. 2007, it was definitely one of the more memorable games that I remember playing. You always like beating the Trojans, that's for sure.
So what do you think of the Fredonia Hillbillies so far this year? Is this your first game watching them play?
Yep, that was my first half. I liked what I saw out there. The Lauder kid plays real tough, runs the ball tough. You know, they got a great quarterback. And what I like saw, they made a couple teams on special teams, a couple plays. So you like to see that.
You know, it's funny you bring about the special teams. Obviously, the kickoff return for a touchdown is the big play. But we also had two very strategic kickoffs that put Southwestern in a tough spot.
Yeah, they were expecting regular kickoffs, and they're doing a couple trick kickoffs, you know? Couple squibs, couple high balls. And I heard that this kid's got a nice boot that kicks off for him, so.
Yeah, they got two soccer players this year for Fredonia, Near and Tabone, and they both do a real nice job. And Near kicks off a little bit more than Tabone, but Tabone's been solid. He's missed one extra point, but that was a 35-yard extra point.
Yeah.
And then he made a 35-yard extra point last week too. So a real weapon for Fredonia
this
year.
I like that. There's three sides of the football, you know. All three of them are very important.
Sides of the football? That's all right. I won't get you, you know.
Three aspects, yeah. Special teams, offense, defense,
I thought it was
right?
kind of oblong.
I've had no time
like
to
that.
Prep, guys. Come on.
Hey, so I'll do a quick stat, and then we'll finish up with Pat. Fredonia right now, I mean, let's see. We had Matt Lauder with 10 carries for 57 yards. We had
Nick Whitfield
had five carries for 66. And which Davis?
Micah Davis.
Thank you. Micah Davis had one for three. Fredonia gaining, I'm still catching up, 110, 123, 126 on the ground. In the air, they were
two
for five for 20 yards. Both receptions went to Brandon Ronsky.
Gain of 11 in the slot.
Very nice.
Yeah, like
very
those.
Nice. And at a good time. One of the things, Pat, I'm sure you can appreciate as a quarterback is the way they mixed the calls up right there. I mean, Fredonia had been a steady diet of run.
I think they got to stick to the run, though. Keep running it with Lauder. He's powerful. And the run pass option, the RPOs, those are what's going to get the job done, especially with the long legs of number six out there.
Yeah, and Fredonia's been talking about that all year, all summer, really. They knew they had the size advantage on the line and would have a back like Lauder and then a quarterback that's 6'7", over 200 pounds, and run a 4.6 himself.
We
saw a couple of those zone reads, and he kept it untouched
Love
for
me
a touchdown.
Love me a run-pass option.
Absolutely.
It's awesome that these kids are running that.
Well, and they're built for it, right? With Lauder, Lauder's a monster inside, and Whitfield can take off and go. So they really are built to run that RPO.
So key, though, we did see Lauder get banged up a little bit at the end and saw him limping a little bit. So we'll have to keep an eye on his health.
It's definitely something to keep an eye on for sure.
And then you got Alex Palouk from the defensive end. You know, he was a trench trophy award nominee last year for his week for his game in Salamanca. Is really limping out there, too. So there'll be two big injuries for Fredonia, even if they're half strength, that could really hurt them in the second half.
Yeah, definitely something also to keep an eye on for sure.
Now, on the Southwestern side, Kennedy ran the ball. In fact, he's run the ball 12 times for 70 yards. He ran the last seven plays, the last seven carries that they had, he was running it, besides his three incompletions. So he really has got the ball in his hands and expects to put them on his back. So he had 12 for 70. Jamison Walsh had three carries for a net one. And Matt Pennis had two carries for 19. They were 6 of 14 passing. Good defense by Fredonia, obviously. 6 of 14 for 80 yards.
Yeah, really. And you know, the heart and soul of Southwestern is Kennedy. Everything goes
absolutely.
For him. And he's a stud. He's won a lot of games and 3-year starter for Southwestern. Took him, I think it was the state semifinals his last sophomore year. Last year as a senior, he lost in the section final, but carried Southwestern to the section final against CSP himself. And just came up against a tough Maritime team that eked out Southwestern section finals. Well,
so what do you boys see as the keys to the second half?
I would have to say stop in 18 for Southwestern for the Hillbillies and continue to ground and pound. You know, these kids, we go back to the summer, these kids work all summer going at it, working hard, playing 7-on-7s to play Southwestern in the regular season, and tonight's the night. So they're going to be playing hard this second half.
I think Fredonia, in order, you know, I mean, right now, everything good we've seen out of Fredonia, the most important, you know, the two keys. One, let's calm down on the penalties. They have 4 for 40 yards.
It's really costly. And cost them at least one touchdown,
I
think.
Very untimely penalties. They were able to bail out Matt Lauder on that last drive with no score, but that was a huge 15 yards.
Big stop down the half.
So penalties, but more important, take care of the ball. My feeling is if Fredonia doesn't turn it over in the second half, they're going to win this game.
And they can't give up. You know, we talked about early, and Southwestern hasn't had that big play that they're known for yet. You know, because they can score a lot in a hurry. We've talked about the whole game. So even if Fredonia does give up a score, they got to, like they have so far, at least make Southwestern have play after play and drive down the field to score. And they got to keep moving the ball themselves. And if they put another couple touchdowns on the scoreboard, it's going to be real tough for Southwestern to come back and win this game.
So what are Southwestern's, if Southwestern's going to win this game, what's their key to the game?
Stop the run. Or you know, they can't give up big plays on the pass. You know, they can't. To me, if they give up two touchdowns, you know, it's 28-35. You know, that would mean at least four touchdowns out of Southwestern in the second half.
Yeah, so they got to come out strong here if they want a chance to win this game.
And they have to come out with a stop here. You cannot go down 28-7. Fredonia does get the ball to start the second half. And Southwestern, I guarantee you, watching them play for years, they are going to try something on the kickoff here. Mm-hmm. It is not going to be a traditional kick it deep. Even on the kickoff return Simon Davis had, that was not a kick deep. That was a line drive that almost got by him. Greg, you comment how nice of a play Davis was able to jump up and tip it to himself, or Fredonia would have been pinned way back inside the 20 more than likely.
If he tips that and it goes sideways, anywhere else, then right back into his arms, you know, that's a live ball.
So this kickoff is number one play right now for Fredonia. They cannot give up the possession here. They have to, if nothing else, recover the ball. That's number one right now.
Pat, you're welcome to stick around. I'm sure your insight will be great, so, you know, feel free. I know you can't hear when you're doing, but what the heck, you can hear us, and it's not like you need that. So you won't get all the direction from up in the booth that says we're on the two shot and the four shot, but other than that, you know, you'll be just fine. So
you'll hear Chip yelling at us, and, you know, let's give a little shout out to Jackson Hickey and Chip Rewald for doing a great job.
And what's our man Derby? I got it written down.
Andrew Derby.
Thank you.
On the scorecard. You know, you guys do a great job every week. We really appreciate you coming out
here. We're slow-moing plays. We're getting, this is leaps and bounds from where we were just a few years ago.
So here we go. This Navis Hoos kicking off for 81.
Is this the same? Wait a second.
Yeah, it's the
Aren't
same
they going
kicker.
In? Oh, no. Okay. Yep. Yes.
And they do kick it deeper, but there's no one there. It's going to go out of bounds. All right. So Fredonia, again, we talked us through. Do they make them kick this again? Or do they take it at the 35?
I like making them kick it again. Unless you've got a boomer kicker, I like making them kick it again.
Fredonia has three touchdowns returned. The flag is ball went out of bounds, Chip. But they're
35.
Yeah, you can choose at 35 or you can push them back 5 yards. It looks like – oh, wait. Sorry about that. I don't know if you guys could hear that or not, but that just blew up my ear. Looks like Fredonia is going to take it at the 35. And this is a crucial stop for Southwestern, and Fredonia wants nothing more to go up by three scores in this drive.
Yeah, let's see what both these teams bring after halftime.
Yeah, and Matt, let me know. I don't see – turn that down a little bit, Chip, please. I don't see any glaring adjustment differences. You know, you got Kenny still the deep safety. But what are they going to do to stop Lauder and Whitfield on the ground here in the second half?
And it looks like Lauder is going full go after being dinged up a little bit in the first half.
Yeah, I can't imagine he'd be doing anything.
He'd have
else.
To cut his leg off to take him out here. And Lauder does get the carry, and he gets a nice run on first down, gain of about six. Yeah, they're going to give him six. So great first down run for Lauder, not showing any sign of a sore leg there. And you got Kennedy coming up giving Lauder a nice shot there. That rivalry that's going on, you know, and the smack talk is going on Twitter, anything else for months now between Lauder and Kennedy. Trips right, lone receiver Fry to the left. Lauder to Whitfield's left, and Whitfield's going to keep it here. Big block by Matt Lauder, knocking 55 right off his feet.
Yeah.
If we get a replay on that, that was a bone-bruising block by Lauder. And here it is, guys. You're going to see it here. Watch Lauder on this lead block. He levels the linebacker of the Trojans, and Whitfield smartly runs right behind him. And here it is. Watch this. Steps up. Boom! Just dropping the linebacker. Litton Whitfield get the first down. Lauder again. Nice hole to the left side. He's got the corner. He's got Kennedy to beat. And Kennedy's able to tackle him right around the 20. But nothing has changed here for this Fredonia offense starting the second half.
And not only is he getting his team going, he's getting the crowd going in the second half.
I mean, look at all those Santa hats right in front of them down there. The Christmas presents. It's Christmas here in October at the Orange Bowl so far for the Fredonia Hillbillies.
Nice. Love to see this many people here down at the Orange Bowl.
The offensive line is just controlling play, by the way. I mean, Lauder is is running hard, but he's got some nice holes. Oh, that's – wow.
I was faked. I was watching Lauder. Whitfield keeps it. Does he get in? He does. Whitfield with the touchdown, diving in the pylon. What a fake two Lauder from Whitfield to keep that play.
Watch number 11 up in the corner. Watch him come. He got faked so badly. He's still going in. He's still going in.
What a great call.
I saw that, and I said, whoa.
But nice stutter. Whitfield to beat Kennedy right there.
That stutter step was
a
really nice move to get himself into the end zone.
You know, and that's something that, you know, college coaches are going to love to see that fake and carrying out the fake. And I know Coach Kubiak and the Fredonia coaching staff has harped on Whitfield for years about the fake, carrying out the fake, run out wide even you hand it off, and it is paying off tonight.
Well, yeah, that was textbook RPO.
And Sal Tabone, extra point attempt is good. Fredonia going up by three scores, 28-7. Here in the third quarter here, we have fourth on the score clock. We'll get that score, but it's the third quarter right now.
So, now what has Southwestern got to be thinking? Just what you talked about, Shannon, the nightmare scenario of Fredonia comes out and just drives down the field. Four plays, ripping off yardage, doing exactly what they did in the first, you know. Southwestern's got to be spinning right now.
Absolutely. You know, and again, now the key for Fredonia, you can't give up a big play. Even if Southwestern tries,
make them take
4 or 5 minutes off the clock, if not more. Make them earn it. They are going to take their shots deep. We've seen them go at Simon Davis repeatedly. That is not going to stop. And let's see what they do. Remember, at the end of the half, Devon McCall switched with Simon Davis, corner safety. Let's see if that continues here defensively, if that was just the end of the half.
I would be taking Whitfield and shadowing, and again, I don't want to overthink this, but I'd have Whitfield shadow Panis. He's the only fella that on the passing game that's been able to hurt Fredonia.
But don't underestimate Devon McCall. He started as a sophomore here as a corner, a shutdown corner. He moved to Dunkirk for a year and played there last year, but he is a solid coverage man himself, and you know, I think the coaches have full confidence in McCall out there one-on-one on a receiver as well. So Connor Anier is on to kick off. Calder Anier, sorry. And let's see if we continue with those little corner sideline.
I got to believe more than ever now.
Absolutely.
God forbid they give up the big.
Crowd's chanting Calder. And he goes deep. Can he get it over his head? He does not. So it's what around about the 12-yard line. Let's check the coverage here. Not able to get away. Good tackles there by Fredonia. Let's see. We had Sam Ezra in there. Let me see that number. I think that was Juan Mendez as well. 57 or 67. Let me see Juan's number. Yeah, 67, Juan Mendez. Sam Ezra had a nice tackle in the open field. So let's take a look. You have Davis back at corner now. And he is out there on Panis. One-on-one, one deep safety, Greg. So they're really taking a chance here.
But they're, look at that.
Turn and they hand off the ball to Walsh. Let's see. He is going to be tackled by... That's Azra. Sam Azra, the sophomore, is having a real nice game overall tonight.
And you watch, you know, Fry's starting probably 15, 16 yards deep on that snap. It's a run up the middle. He's backing up to start. So coaches have told him, listen, we're not giving up the long one.
Well, and we've seen Kennedy do some real nice play action himself today, too, off, you know, like under center, fake roll out, and complete some deep passes. So absolutely. Double safety look here.
Look at him back up.
Nice. I mean, he's tackled immediately by, I believe that's the Davis brothers even out there. Simon and Micah making the tackle. It's going to be third down now for Southwestern.
It'll be third and three.
So, yeah, that was I think I was dropping back in zone, and they have mixed up between zone and man. Gave Panis a little bit of room to make that catch, but no extra yards after the catch, and that's big for the Fredonia defense. Kennedy and shotgun, one back to his right.
Boy, they've already got a big third down, huh?
Yeah. Kennedy fakes it. No one throws it deep over the middle, and he completes it.
Yeah,
there is a face mask. And we've seen that, you know, you watch Southwestern. They are known for hitting those guys in the seams over the middle like that. And it wasn't bad coverage by McCall. He was right on it, but that was a perfect throw by Kennedy. And we're going to see it here on replay. He does. There's fake to nobody there. A little miscommunication, but what a throw.
Yeah, right over the top, right down the seam.
So that's not the first big third down we've seen Kennedy convert on the pass, and they're going to tack on some extra yards, whether it's 5 or 15.
Oh, it's got to be
15. Face mask.
I mean, he grabbed on and lasso. You know, that was rodeo data.
And it is going to be the big one. So that'll put the ball at Fredonia's 29-yard line.
First and 10 for Southwestern from the 30-yard line.
That is what Southwestern needed, but let's see if the Hillbillies can bounce back here, get a stop.
Yeah, that bend but don't break defense that we've seen a lot this year. This would be a good time to bring it out again. Kenny takes it, hands off to Walsh, the deep back, has some room this time. Finally brought down by 22, Micah Davis. That's a good 9-yard gain there.
Well, they're moving it for the first, huh? They're giving him, must have given him 10.
Must be giving him the 10. So it'll be another back-to-back first downs for the Trojans. We saw that in a few plays in a row on their one scoring drive so far today. They had three first downs in a row against Fredonia. See if they can duplicate. Kennedy's looking, correcting his sophomore running back Walsh to get to his right. Kennedy keeps it himself up the middle. Not a lot there. That's number 70. I think that's Owen Rush. It hit him first. Yeah, that is 70. Owen Rush, sophomore lineman, doing a real nice job, and he's going to be a real good lineman for two more years to come for the Hillbillies.
The other one there is, I thought.
Not Fredonia, though.
No. We know they've got, I mean, we were talking about it before, they've got, you know, several people well over 200.
Kennedy back in shotgun, hands it off to the back, looking to get the edge, and he can't get it. Lauder comes up and makes the tackle. It's going to be third and long again for the Trojans.
The defense held their ground there, held their sections, and really forced them to make a decision.
Yeah, forced them to cut it off to Lauder. You know, I really thought, if you see us when he first took off, that there was going to be more running room than there was. But it was a good closure pursuit by the Fredonia defense there. Looks like they have the edge initially, but good job by the corner, Whitfield, containing, forcing them right into Lauder. And if you're going to force it anyone in the Fredonia defense, you want to force him right to Matt Lauder. He doesn't miss many from the inside.
The kid plays with a lot of confidence.
Pace is in the backfield now to the right of Kennedy. We haven't seen a lot.
Walsh is calm down. So they kind of traded those spots.
Just gets
it
off.
I thought it was going to be a screen.
Nice play. You got Izzy Martinez and is it Alex Palou battling through a leg injury for the sack. You know, half a sack each, so now you have fourth and long, and that's a big tackle because Kenny gets through those two. He might even have the first down.
Yeah, it looks like he's definitely fighting through some pain out there as well.
Oh, absolutely. We saw him limping early, and he's battling through it. This is Southwestern. You don't get hurt in this game.
Yeah, you don't come out.
So Southwestern is, I mean, this is a fourth and nine, almost a must-have, not only because of the score. Oh, look at this. We got Walsh coming in in the shotgun. Kennedy.
So this is an interesting matchup. You got one-on-one receiver out here. Kenny's looking to his left. It's incomplete. Micah Davis on the coverage. It's a little low.
Huge play by the defense.
And another big stop, and offense will get the ball at the 20. So we talked about a bend, but don't break.
Well, and that was not only is it important that they got into Fredonia territory and then died on downs. They chewed up 5.5 minutes. I got to look, at least 5 minutes on that drive. 10:28 to 5. So that was a 5-minute drive to get nothing. All the way to the red zone, and like I said,
close play there. Close play there.
Oh yeah, he could have completed. It was a little low.
He threw it low. Yeah.
But when you're under pressure all game long, that's what starts to happen to some of the best quarterbacks out there.
Bet we see him run up the middle. Yep.
Yeah. Oh man, Lauder just runs over number 14 of Southwestern, Max Marshall. We could hear that up here, guys.
And who wants to take the? The bet that we see the RPO now.
No.
It's a steady diet.
And Marshall is going out after that hit. I mean, and that's a good job by the coaches because he really took a big hit by Lauder. And check him out, make sure he's okay. I like that by the Southwestern coaching staff. All right to Lauder again, and he's just driving, carrying Southwestern Trojans. It's going to be real. Yeah, he's going to have enough for the first down based on Bon Giovanni's, and Lauder is down himself here. I wonder if he's cramping up or not, but we've seen this a few times with Lauder. He's been playing hard all over the place.
Mm-hmm. And does look like a cramp.
Yeah, and the way, and they're stretching, and the way he's squirming around, we've seen that a few times with him, and cramps hurt. They lock you up, and it feels like you cannot move.
Yep. I don't like getting one in the bed, much less in the middle of a football field.
Now, who does Fredonia go to now if Lauder's cramping up?
Well, Micah Davis will go in at running back. It's been that 1-2 punch all year. You got Micah smaller, a little quicker than Lauder. Mm-hmm. Lauder's got a little bit more power. But Mike had over 100 yards down in Allegheny in a game on 5 carries, so he can break the big one too. But I think he catches defenses off guard because you're not expecting to hand off to the second back. And that's worked well. Do you throw it here on it down, or do you just let Whitfield run it this
time?
Maybe
stick with the RPOs, but
instead
of running it in the inside, run it to the 6-7 hole.
Once again, if they don't turn it over, they're going to win, particularly now. So I can't imagine not keeping it in the hand of Whitfield or Davis, who's somebody that's handled the ball.
He cannot put any.
I definitely like Whitfield in this situation.
Right. Yeah, first and 10 right at the 30.
Lauder's walking off. He's got the pickle juice in his mouth. I guarantee you that's what he's chewing on, is pickles and pickle juice. You can see the trainer, Chad Mason, there with a cup of pickle juice. Give it to him. So it's definitely cramping issues. So Lauder will be back. Get him hydrated. But that'll keep happening. It'll keep cramping up on him. It's hard to rehydrate yourself this quickly. So something to keep an eye on. Hey, let people know pizza's in the snack stand. Announce that pizza has arrived for the snack stand.
The really important stuff.
Yeah. All right, Davis is behind Whitfield here, and they go right to Davis, showing a lot of confidence, but there is nothing there. He's met by 70 and 40 in the backfield. That is Kenyon Davidson and Edwin Gibbon ready for that run play.
Yeah, that one looked like it took a little bit to develop.
Yeah, you know, you got your backup running back. You don't get him a lot of snaps in practice. Messes up timing a little bit. And Southwestern is ready for that play. So second and long. Has Whitfield had a pass attempt in the second half yet? I don't think he has he?
No. No, they just ran it down the field the last drive.
You know, and their coaching staff is taking their time here. You know, and now, you know, the fact official is counting, and Fredonia is going to take a
timeout.
Fredonia. You know, you saw the back judge counting there. You don't want to take a delay of game. So good timeout. Hopefully it doesn't come back to hurt them later on. But when you're up by three scores here, you don't want to make a bad mistake like you talked about, Greg.
Yeah, and I mean, Lauder going out has just kind of discombobulated the offense. I'm sure they came out and said, we're just going to steady diet this thing. And all of a sudden, you've got Lauder on the sidelines. Now we're making decisions. We're thinking, you know, coaches are thinking, players are thinking. That last time when they called the timeout, you saw them all going to their wristbands.
Yeah.
So I'm sure the coaches aren't happy about it, but I think it just got, you know, a little out of sync. Timeout's probably a great call to get that back, regroup, and start over.
Absolutely. You do not want a big mistake here. And if you end up punting, it's not the end of the world, although obviously you'd like to get a first down here and run more time off the clock. But you definitely don't want to give them a short field. Trips right, lone receiver Fry down in front of us, so Whitfield's left, Davis to Whitfield's right, and Whitfield's going to the air.
Nice.
He's going to find Brandon Ronsky. And he is going to get tackled just short of the first down. Lauder is snapping on his helmet as we speak, folks. Is he going to go back in on this play?
Whitfield's pass complete to Ronsky.
So it's going
to
be third and one.
I do like that play
call
a lot. Showed some confidence. Showed confidence in the team right there.
Also safe over the middle. You know, I mean, that's got to keep, you know, if something ugly happened, it's not going as a six.
When they go trips, I just feel like they're going to be outmanned over there, Southwestern.
Look for Whitfield to keep it here on short yard situation as all year. No, they give it to Davis, and he's going to have a first down, taking it out to about the 46-yard line. Big first down for Fredonia Hillbillies after Lauder going out of the game and having second and long.
Fredonia first down.
And again, the offensive line is just control. Both ends, offensive and defensive lines, are just controlling play today. I mean, just dominating more than anywhere else.
Absolutely.
They do have a noticeable size difference over the Southwestern linemen as well.
Davis again. Not a lot there, but he's able to fall forward. See if they give him the real spot here. If you guys notice, he actually rolled over the pile before he hit the ground. But they don't really give that to him.
It looks like they're going with that original
spot.
Yeah,
but he never hit the ground there. You know, watch it on replay. To me, he got another yard. Again, you're biased, Dad. But if you watch this, he doesn't hit the ground. He rolls over top of them. You know, he's not down, not on the ground. He doesn't go down.
2 yards.
Yeah, right. So that's a bad spot by the official. I know. I know. Whitfield running the clock down. Good move. Fakes the Lauder back in the field. Going deep to Fry. He had him just overthrown. Taking a shot there in second eight, which I like, but now not converting. You have third and long. And it does stop the clock.
The Whitfield to Fry connection, also a pretty good basketball connection right there.
Absolutely.
Yeah, you've got, this is the third or fourth year, I mean, you lived it, but a lot of basketball players, I always think of Fry as a basketball player more than
absolutely.
Basketball players playing football. We've seen it the last 4 or 5 years where it's really helped the team.
Go jump up, get the ball.
Ethan Fry will be the starting quarterback for Fredonia next year after Whitfield graduates. But you know what? Who cares about next year? And he's hit right there, Whitfield to Fry. And that's going to be another hillbilly first down into Trojan territory right about the 41-yard line.
For another first down.
And this is, I mean, this is textbook for the Fredonia offense right here.
Yes.
Grind it out, first down, clock first down, running. Run that clock.
Time.
I mean, there's no way that, and I mean, from the play calling we've seen, there's no way they're not going to end the quarter with the ball.
Water's back in there. Yeah,
he's been back in the few. He hasn't carried the ball yet, but he's back in the last couple plays. I expect we're going to see him right now, and we do. And there's Lauder running hard once again. Gain of about 7 there.
Oh, I think he's maybe 9.
More than that. Okay. Yeah. Let's see.
Split the difference.
8. Yep. Gain of 8. Second down and 2. And all sorts of options now for Coach Balvino.
Run
calling
the ball.
These plays. I know.
I thought he's done a nice job tonight.
Injury? Yes, he has. And I... You know, both Greg and I in past years have been critical of the Fredonia coaching staff and their play calling. You know, they get stubborn. Oh, we're going to go out and run the ball. Guys, they got 8-9 guys in the box. So this year it's been the exact opposite. Well, if you watched Salamanca's game last week, Lauder didn't have a carry in the first half because they had 7 guys in the box all bunched up. And what does Fredonia come out and do? Throw the ball over the field and Whitfield scramble.
They got the athletes to do it.
Yeah, and they brought Lauder in to close the game. 10, 11 carries, 140 yards in the second half. Mm-hmm. So they've done an outstanding job calling plays based on what the defense is giving them.
It looks like that's the game plan here in the second half as well, or as we go in.
And you, getting closer to the fourth quarter. You saw it without, you know, We talked about it at the top, is that the left side of Fredonia, the left side of Fredonia's line has got to have 80 pounds, you know, 40 pounds a man over the other two fellas they're going against.
That was the opposite of the old Southwestern.
Right. And even
they had some big boys.
Trips right, Fry's alone here on the left. But they're going to give it to Lauder, and he's met by 70. That's big-time contact there, guys. Kenyon Davidson hits Lauder. Lauder falls forward, but that was a nice hit.
Lauder up the middle for no
third
gain.
Down.
Bring up 3rd and 2.
And they're going to run that down to the end of the third quarter with the score. Fredonia,
the score is Fredonia 27.
Man. Fredonia probably had the ball.
7.
Yes.
8-9 minutes of that quarter.
Well, absolutely. We had the 5-minute, you know. They had that first drive was just lightning fast. The first drive only took 1.5 minutes. So let's see, with that 1.5 minutes, and then they got it with 5:15 left. So actually, they 6:45, about 6:45, which leaves the 5:15. Every once in a while, Pat, I got these numbers right.
All right. I'm glad you're on top of that.
So, guys, I mean, going into this fourth quarter, let's, you know, and again, Southwestern out, right? But, you know, we talked about this beginning of the game. Southwestern, if this continues, they're going to lose their second game in league. Right now, they are down by 20 points, and that is huge. The most you can get for, point difference is plus 20. Southwestern is going to have to scramble unless there's some upsets with Salamanca or Fredonia gets some. But Fredonia has a 2-game lead in Southwestern and a head-to-head in Salamanca. Yeah,
right.
So this 20 points right now. So there's two wild card teams that make the playoffs out of the 8. But plus 20 loss is a really big loss too. So that is huge going in this fourth quarter. Not only do you want to come back and try to win, but you want to get that point differential. If you don't mm-hmm. win, you want to get that point differential down, and Fredonia wants to win by plus 40 if you, in this game with the history that these two teams have. Here we go, fourth quarter, third and about three. Whitfield taking the snaps, going to give it to who else? Lauder, and it will be a Fredonia first down. And Whitfield got hit late. He's talking to the official there. Like, why am I getting hit? And the official's not going to call it. And Whitfield wasn't running there. You know, if you're running right. like you're faking it, then, hey, I thought he had the ball. Mm-hmm. But he was just standing back, to, you know.
What's the debate here, by the way?
I don't know.
He clearly had the first down.
And they are giving it to him. First down, Fredonia.
It's like the far side official didn't have quite as good of a spot as the Fredonia side official.
So a little bit anxious in official time. So Greg Sherlock is talking about what we just were and why Nick Whitfield's able to get hit. And again, we don't have the ability to go back and watch it again. And we just saw Whitfield on the ground and complaining. So I don't. Did you guys see it actually live? Because I didn't.
I didn't, but they've been hitting him all game now. On the RPO, you better expect to get
yes.
hit. But that was not an RPO.
It was not. He was standing straight handoff, just standing straight back. And Whitfield's going to keep it here. Hesitation in Southwestern. There's 70 again. He's had a nice game. Kenyon Davidson, another big tackle for Southwestern. No gain on the play, guys?
Maybe one.
Let's see where they spot it.
I'd like to see them go with maybe something else here, use the wide side of the field.
Take a shot here.
Looks like single coverage there.
I mean,
they
absolutely. You got some room there if you take a shot. Of course, incomplete stops the clock, but they are going deep.
Away.
They're going deep to Davis. He's there. He's overthrown. He had his guy beat. Whitfield could not connect to Davis for a second touchdown of the game, making third and long, just what you called.
Third and nine.
I see them going for it here on fourth down as well, though. So you got you got two more plays here.
Absolutely. So you're probably going to see either a short safe pass to get a completion, hopefully, and keep
that
the clock
slot
rolling.
Guy, I like him in the slot.
Right, or you're going to see a handoff to Lauder, get 4 or 5 yards at least, hopefully, and get a chance of fourth down. Or obviously you could run with Whitfield. So really you could do anything is what I'm trying to get at. And they do give it to Lauder, and he is just tackled. For a minute there, I thought he was going to break through.
Mm-hmm. All right. Frankly, any positive yards, any time the clock is running, you know, we're getting closer to mm-hmm. locking this thing down.
No, it's a good play call. So now you got fourth and what do you got? Fourth
five,
and three?
Four.
So they got to get, where's the ball's right on the 25, isn't it? Or no? Yeah, I think it's on the 25. Looks like they got about three to go. Need to get to the 22. So, again, you can do a lot of things. RPO, Whitfield, Lauder. You don't have to worry about throwing an incomplete pass. Clock's going to stop if you don't get the first down anyway. And they are looking to go to the air, and they go to the slot, and he couldn't. Little too much mustard on that one. Whitfield threw that a little too hard, I think, where if he just used a little touch, I think he could have got it in there. Mm-hmm. But that'll be a turnover on downs against Fredonia. But they chewed up a lot of time there. Now Southwestern really needs to score quick, and he really had time to run the ball anymore.
Fredonia's defense has been dominating ever since they scored in the first quarter. That Southwestern hasn't scored since.
I mean, they took that at 5:15, Pat. You were talking about, you know, I cut us off because of the quarter, but that was truly a 2:15, 7.5 minute drive right there.
All right, you know.
And that's what you want right here in the second half.
And they do. They're going to hand it off to Walsh, though, and Walsh has got some room. He's going to be ankle tackle. That's a big tackle. I thought he was getting to the sideline there. Yeah.
Well,
I think that's Devon McCall. I didn't even see where he came out of to make that tackle for, you know, it was a gain of 5. That's great, but it looked like he was going to get 25.
And they are
watch down here in front of us, Davis on Payne. No, they're handed off again to Walsh.
Trying to speed up the tempo, Southwestern looked like it was there.
Yeah, but they got to score a bundle of points.
That's another tackle there by Sam Azrat. Third and short here. Pseudo huddle even. Yeah, they are truly huddling, not even pseudo. Which, what's that tell you as former coach, former player, guys, Southwestern's mentality right now?
They have to have more urgency.
But are they really thinking they can win the game the way they're calling offense right now? You know what I mean?
Yeah. Look at the linemen, their shoulders are down, their heads, they're physically beat up.
Davis misses the tackle. One man to meet, that's Lauder, and Lauder's going to catch him, but that's a big gain, and that's a big missed tackle by Simon Davis there. Lost his footing, but he's got to at least get a hold of him to make that tackle.
Yeah, that was a nice catch there by the Southwestern player. Made a nice little spin move, got himself to the outside.
Yeah, he went up and got it without a doubt. Panties, leading receiver, has had a good game so far, and beat Davis pretty good on that one. Clock stop, ball's out of bounds, looking to the right. He's got a guy open, and Walsh is able to go up and get it. So two quick big pass plays for Southwestern to bring the score within two here. And Tabone must have missed that extra point where we thought he made it,
correct.
And we didn't correct that on our keeping the score of 27. And, this is a nice job by Walsh, too. It was a little behind him, but he goes and gets it for the easy
still
completion, that seam. And that if they had cover two safety there, wasn't in position at all. On to attempt the extra point is Hoos. A high snap. Fannis is going to have to keep it. Tries to throw. It's completed, but nowhere near the end zone. So that's a big break for Fredonia to keep that 14-point lead now. Where, they make that, it's only a 13-point lead. So, nice break there for Fredonia. 8:17 left. Not over yet, folks. That was a big touchdown for Southwestern.
Yeah, Fredonia needs I still think we're comfortable with if there's not a turnover, but.
Well, if they go three and out here or something, that changes a lot of things, too.
It does give Southwestern a little confidence there, scoring on two big plays.
Sure. I just finished commenting about how, the shoulders are down. We're talking about running the ball.
Bada bing, they have a big play. Yep. All of a sudden, their shoulders are up now.
Yep.
Fredonia has to have the drive like they seemingly just had. Eat up some clock, get a couple first downs.
They need to smell blood
points.
Here. Yeah, they need to smell blood. They got to want this, right? This is, talk about working hard all summer, everything else, conditioning.
This drive
right here. So Fredonia is able to respond to that touchdown, drive down the field, eat up clock. They can seal this game right here. They go three and out, turn the ball over, whatever. Southwestern is right back in it. So this is big.
Whitfield should go into the huddle, look his boys in the face, tell them we're going to go score a touchdown.
Absolutely. And, again, it starts in those trenches. And guys, Southwestern is known for all sorts of trick kicks here. So they got to recover this ball right now, too. That would be a huge blow to Fredonia if Southwestern is somehow able to hop onto an onside short kickoff right here. Here's Hoos with the kickoff. And it is an onside kick. It does go 10 yards now. There's a scrum. It looks like Fredonia's got it.
That was pretty good onside
yes,
kick.
Was.
What a play.
Yeah, it was.
What a play by the Fredonia player to snag that.
And I don't.
Looks like it was Lauder.
Let's see who got. And it's that in between here, right? They don't know if they should go up and touch it before 10 yards, right? You see him stop right there.
Right.
And then it takes that hop, and that's a good job. I can't see who jumped on that. But that was an outstanding play there. It might have been Sam Azra at number 20, but I don't know that for sure. And now Fredonia's first downs.
Big
you need
play.
First downs.
Big time special teams play right there. That was not an easy.
No.
It was a very good kick by Southwestern kicker.
You know, that hop was came up high, and then it just took off into the Fredonia's feet. So we got a bunch formation. Lotters to his right here. Look for Whitfield to keep it. No, they're going to give it to Devon McCall. Running outside, staying. You know, and I don't – Devon McCall's a receiver. Like, what do we – I don't like that call at all. Yeah, play, right? Yeah, but it's like –
McCall on the pitch.
Don't get too smart here. You know, don't outthink yourself.
What do we do, get one?
Yeah. Gain of one. Ball's right at the 50. You know, we saw a little bit of that last week, and it didn't work either, you know, against Salamanca. Go with what's got you
here. Linebacker on him now. Maybe look for McCall now in the slot.
Yeah, a little out pattern here.
Keep it on the ground as well.
Right here, Whitfield's running the clock all the way down. Lotter's right behind Whitfield. Lotter's going to get the ball. And he's hit right at the line of scrimmage. Nothing there. And again, Whitfield is hit.
He went low as well.
Yeah, and that's a dirty. And that the official's got to take control of that. There's no need. Whitfield's not running. He's not threatening. He's getting teed off on. If it's an option play or RPO, yeah, you can hit him. He's standing there running backwards. That is not okay there, but they're getting away with it. So now you have a crucial third down here. The last thing you want to do is punt the ball. Motion by Ronski. They're going to fake to him. Going to his right. Whitfield under all sorts of pressure and has to throw it away.
Smart play to throw it away.
That stops the clock, though, on the other hand.
Pass goes incomplete.
So punt team for Fredonia is going on. So this is the last thing you wanted to see if you're Fredonia. Is a punt, and it really goes back to that. I do not like that first play with McCall at all. I don't know why they're calling that.
I would have liked to see them use the wide side of the field there.
Yeah, right. Owen
we'll
Rush
see what
back
we can get,
to punt.
With the punt here.
Nice punt directed to the left. Davis down there hoping for a roll.
Fredonia bounce. Inside
the
20.
Down around the 12-yard line.
Yeah, the Fredonia crowd is a little hostile.
Yeah. Well, you know, they see their quarterback getting teed off on. It's
you especially don't like those low knee blows
right.
as well.
I mean, literally that last one, I watched it. He was backpedaling away from the play, mm-hmm. and they still went low. The back judge is right there and refusing to call that. So now the last thing Fredonia can do is give up the big play. You got to have cover two safety here, right?
87 yards. Make them earn that 87
right.
yards. Right.
You know, cover, and they're going right back. It's interesting. You got Davis on and Penny's out here all alone. You need to get him some help over the top. I don't know what we're thinking here. You got one safety. Let him run the ball.
And you know, number four, Penny's going to get the ball.
Yeah.
I mean, that's where.
It's a handoff to Walsh.
Great.
Walsh breaks one tackle, brought down by Davis, but it's going to be a first down.
Southwestern does have a little momentum here.
Yes, they do. The last thing Fredonia wants to do is get on their heels. Clock should be running. Now it is. The box is set. 6:18 clock running. Southwestern right back to the line. Cannot give up a quick score here.
Boy, I don't know why they don't have a second safety. Right?
Walsh gets the ball again. And he, again, that was close to breaking that one. There's an ankle tackle there. I didn't see who got it.
Wait a second. We got a recipe here. Walsh runs it twice, and then they turned it loose in that last series. Walsh ran it twice, and then they threw the 47 and the 20. Oh, that's
a penalty. Too many men, yep.
Free play.
Yeah.
Didn't
use it. Unfortunately, right.
Now they'll take the penalty because it'll stop the clock, right? Even though he gained probably five. Oh, they're going to run the clock if they decline it, so they've got to take the penalty.
And Davis was just over to defensive coordinator Justin Sherlock, hey, they're going to throw it. He's lobbying. Give me some help deep, boys.
Right.
And they do. You got, let's see. McCall is still up at the linebacker spot, so they're sticking one safety.
Now, I don't want to throw any gasoline on this fire, but I don't have a penalty against Southwestern all game. I'm trying to, I'm hoping.
A lot
I'm
of
wrong,
laundry, yeah.
I think they had one false start. I think there was a false start early against Southwestern. That's the one I can think of.
You're right.
But they had to call that one. Still one deep safety. See, I'm one-on-one coverage.
He is deep. Here's the throw.
Kennedy scrambling to his right, direct hit by Davis as he's thrown, forcing it. No way, another flag.
Wait,
if that's
a
late hit on Davis, that is a ridiculous call. Let's see what it is.
Can't be a hit on the quarterback.
No, there's no way. He hit him as he was throwing it.
Are they going to try? They can't call him for grounding either.
He's outside
He's outside the box. He's throwing it. And they had a receiver in the general area.
I think
it was
on a lineman by Fredonia, maybe a late hit after on one of their linemen.
I don't know. Let's see. Do we got any replay on that, Chip? See if we can. It was on Southwestern, legal man downfield. Is that what that was? Oh, no. Wait. What's this? He went like this. That's, of course, none of us can see.
Quarterback's behind.
He went to his head there.
I think he called intentionally grounding, though, as well.
Yeah, but he's outside the. Is that a high school thing, though?
Somewhere, but there was a. I don't know if it
is. He got hit as he threw it, too, so
I
don't know.
I can't imagine calling
ground. It might have been a legal man downfield. Isn't that what. Yeah. I think that might be a legal man downfield, like lineman downfield, I think is the call, which makes sense. You're scrambling all over the place.
Yep.
You lose track of time. You think your quarterback's going to take off running the ball.
After the penalty, it'll be second and 16 for the Trojans.
And so we got, again, I'm telling you, I go too deep safety here if I'm Fredonia, but they're still not. And you got Panties out here one-on-one on Davis. Now they are going too deep, but you need to get help over the top. And they're looking out here. They're going to go to Dave. No, back over the middle. Ooh. It's a little high, but he was open. A little too high. Intended receiver there is three. Ashton Matthews, a senior.
That's intended for Matthews.
So now we have third and long.
Third and 16.
Looks to be another passing down here for the Southwestern.
I think
Fredonia guys has to bring the pressure, the D-line.
Well, I think that's what they're talking about. Yeah, don't let Kennedy sit back and throw. Get him uncomfortable.
It does look like they got four back now.
Yep.
So they got two safeties.
They got a bunch set here down in front of us to Kennedy's left. He's looking right, going to come back left, trying to get a wheel route there. Now he's going to run it. And, oh, he's able to. Oh, he's got it, I believe.
Boy, it's
and
close.
That's Kennedy-esque right there.
Big play right there by Kennedy.
And you've seen Kennedy do that for years now.
Thought he was going to get tackled two, three times.
Big first down, clock is, should be running now. The box is set, 4:50, Southwestern right back to line of scrimmage. Fredonia really needs to make a play here, really needs a play. Right back to Walsh, tries to bounce it outside, nothing there, cuts it back in, finds some room. Good yardage on first down for Southwestern, getting out to the Hillbilly 45.
But a 40-second running play that gains 8 yards or 5 yards. Fredonia will give them all the 5-yard carries they want to get.
Yes, I agree. But the clock isn't as against Southwestern as we thought after that 3-and-out against Fredonia. And I keep looking down here to the – Kennedy's going to keep this one. A lot of room. Breaks one tackle, can't get away, but is going to get a first down. And there's a lot of excitement going over there in that Southwestern sideline.
Kennedy with gain of 10.
Southwestern should, if they get right to line scrimmage, snap the ball right around 4 minutes. Down two scores.
Yeah, Kennedy's showing the type of player he is right now.
going deep. Incomplete.
And doesn't that, look to be any flags.
Yeah. That was close. Walsh had a slight step, and he definitely has a height advantage over Micah Davis there, but he couldn't quite come up with it. Good job by Davis staying with it.
Yeah, it was a great second effort to get that ball loose.
Let's take a look here. Did Davis rip it out or Walsh just drop it? I think he just dropped it.
A little of both. I mean, I don't think he ever had it.
He's tugging.
Yep.
Definitely scrapping out there. Second down and 10. 3:49
inside four
left.
Minutes.
Hand off to Walsh this time up the middle. Again, we'll take that. Davis and others in on that tackle.
Yeah, Walsh is having a much better second half
Yes, he is. And he's only a sophomore. That young man's going to have a nice couple-year career going in the next two seasons. Clock still running, down to 3:25. Kenny under center, rolls to his right. Throws short. Is that?
I think he got it. Yep, 21.
Yep. Okay, that's caught. Man, that's a nice catch. He was hit.
Nice
as
catch right there.
Cameron, if anything, I thought it might almost been pass interference.
I thought the Fredonia play was a little early.
Yeah, exactly.
Who made that catch?
Cameron Lemk, 21.
Yep.
And they rolled to the short side, Greg.
Yeah, play action bootleg by Kennedy.
Right hand,
there.
They want to be on his.
Nice,
you know,
throw on the run.
Go, clock down. It's going to be 3 minutes about in this snap. Kennedy takes it. He's looking to his left, throws deep over the middle.
Oh!
And it's intercepted by Ethan Fry. And he's going to be brought down right just past midfield. And you see Kennedy knowing
listen
that's a huge
crowd.
Interception and a big play by number 8, Ethan Fry, because he had a receiver there, just threw it a little high.
Kennedy's pass intercepted by Ethan Fry, and it's
what a big turnover for Fredonia. First turnover of the game, guys, right?
Yep. That's that big-time play Fredonia was looking for. Fry made it happen.
And I think you're going to see a handoff to Lauder Whitfield running himself, right?
Kennedy had him open. He just sailed the throw.
But what a game. I mean, my hat's off to Aiden Kennedy. I've had a lot of respect for him over the years, and he is one heck of a football player. He's a gamer.
As a football fan, you hate to see
it's going to be too many men.
Play like that,
I can't believe they just let him get away with that. Pass completed to Davis.
Why
literally right in front of the official. His knee was down.
Oh.
Right in front of the official. Guys, you can see. I don't know if we can see it. There was a Southwestern player running off the field. Didn't get off, and they don't call too many men.
Which
I don't understand. Yeah, I don't understand that. That's he just ignored it. Just blatantly ignored it. That is ridiculous. Shame on that official. I don't understand. Sirianni's only have so many control in this section, for crying out loud. Lauder on the handoff. Running hard out to the 41. Going to be third down. Timeout here, Southwestern.
Timeout, Southwestern.
Now, do we know how many timeouts Southwestern has?
They either have one more or.
Yeah, I'm not sure if they called. We called one this half. I know we called one this half, but.
In the Fredonia High School student section comes alive here towards the end of the game.
Did they see Santa? Is Santa
there
here?
There you go.
They're hoping for some presents under the tree.
Absolutely. Ethan Fry just got himself a nice present. What a big first down.
Yeah,
the first down here would seal the – I mean, and what do you do if you're Fredonia? I mean, do you punt them deep?
You got to give it to number five.
Well, five or Whitfield. You know, one or the other. Has to be the play here. Let Whitfield read it. Lauder is limping, but he is not going to show it when he runs the ball. I can guarantee you that. So here we go, third and a long two. Whitfield's going to keep it, foul Lauder, and he's going to be stopped. He's going to get right around to about the 40. Southwestern is going to call another timeout. So it's going to be fourth and a short two, fourth and about two, 1:55 remaining.
Southwestern. I'm telling you, I don't punt the ball at this point.
I think you go. I think you go for it.
You go for it. The worst thing that happens is you run another 20 seconds, 30 seconds off.
Well, you're not going to run 20, 30 seconds off if you don't get it. If you don't get it, because it'll stop on change of possession. So
if you accidentally kick into the end zone.
I'll kneel down right now.
Yeah. Oh, I know.
It's only 20-yard difference.
No, I get it. I'm not saying don't go for it.
I'm almost kneeling.
Go win the game.
I don't mean kneel it down. I want Whitfield to run a sneak. You know, let's not the only thing that can screw this up is a turnover or touchdown, you know, block punt.
Or
something.
Do you do something here where you fake inside and you have Whitfield
rolling. You just talked about not being
too cute. No, Whitfield rolling out, you know, with a designed run play that at least, even if he doesn't get it, fake the Lauder in the middle.
Use some time.
That's going to take up some more time. And Whitfield beat someone in the open field. He's got a lot of room to the left side. And they got trips left over there.
I think you're going to hand it off to
the Iron Shotgun. Mm-hmm.
Which.
They are stuffing the line, of course.
Yeah.
What else are you going to do?
And Whitfield's looking to pass. Didn't like what he saw initially.
Oh, there you go. Stay in bounds.
And he's going to get the first. Oh, there's a flag late.
They're going to call clip.
You saw it?
Yep. They're going to call. It looked clean to me.
1:46.
Well, we're going to need to see it right here.
Jackson, see if you or on the camera, take
here
a look
go.
At the left
here
end.
There you go.
All right, so here's
and it's going to be the receiver comes in.
No, well, that's a good block. That's a legal block all day.
Head was around him.
He stayed
high.
Yeah, that's a
horrid call.
Yep. But if you look at the fan section down in our end zone right now, we got on the camera.
What are they calling, by the way? A crackback?
You know what? He didn't lead with his hand. He led with his shoulder.
Right.
You're supposed to lead with your hands, though. So maybe it's definitely not a block in the back. Now they are going to punt it with 1:46. That's right, because that was on fourth down.
Unfortunate call. Another flag. Another flag on Fredonia.
Did he just give a holding?
It better not have been a holding. Because
if it was anything, it was a crackback.
He gave the signal, though. I watched him pull his arm down.
Brings up a fourth and 11.
Unbelievable.
From the 49.
And this is a big punt, and, you know, they got two returners back. You do not want to give up a big return here. So you got to get your cover team downfield and not get and pin them back. Owen Rush back to punt from the Hillbilly 37. High snap. Rush goes up and gets it. Lower line.
Way to get that.
That's
by Rush.
Yeah. You know what? I don't mind that at all. No chance of return. 1:15 left now. Down by two scores. At most, Southwestern has one timeout because I know they've called two. Correct.
Mm-hmm.
So now just don't give that big play. Don't give up
that
big play.
Extra defensive back out there.
Without a doubt, safeties cannot let anyone get behind them. I mean, you almost go zone now, don't you, to keep the safeties back
mm-hmm.
and everything
mm-hmm.
in front of you.
Mm-hmm.
This is a little, remember the Dunkirk-Fredonia overtime game where in the end zone down to our left, and half of it was Fredonia, half was Dunkirk. Right now, it's all Fredonia. One more stop needed by this Fredonia defense, up 27-13, 1:14 left. Bunch formation. Don't get sucked in your Fredonia defense here. They're going to do a halfback pass. Halfback pass here all day. And Fry falls or he would have had it. If Fry does not slip there, that's an easy interception. But you can see that developing all the way, that thrown back. It was going to be a halfback pass.
The Orange Bowl deuce strikes again.
What, the field isn't good here? Is that what you're saying? Live to see another day here by Southwestern, down 27-13, 1:08 left. Second 10 from their own 32-yard line.
A them going that on first down, I don't look to for them to do anything else like that again. Just stick to their quarterback here.
Yeah, keep the ball in Kennedy's hands. Let him make plays.
Fredonia's only rushing three here.
Short pass. He's going to get out of bounds. You know, that's fine. That completed to number 21, Cameron Lanks. Had a nice game today. He's going to be third and short. Nick Whitfield steps up and forced him out of bounds. 102 remaining. So nice job for Southwestern. You got a positive yardage. Very little time off the clock. Kenny dropping back, looking a little wheel route here. Oh. Kennedy under pressure. What a job avoiding the rush. Still on his feet, broke two more tackles. Davis has got to stay the outside here. And Davis makes an ankle tackle. Simon Davis, that is. It's going to be a first down, 46 seconds left. And what another great play by Aiden Kennedy, guys.
That kid can play. He made about six Fredonia defenders miss him on that one.
Absolutely.
I thought he was going to get tackled in the backfield.
He broke two in the backfield, two up here. Yep. And Southwestern, you're right. Good call, Gray. It's the last timeout. Still down by two scores of 46 seconds left, yo. So we'll adjust that a little bit. It's 46 on the official Beaver Club clock. Great donation by the Fredonia Beaver Club. And what a game, guys. I mean, the scoring has slowed down a lot in the second half. I will say that overall. I mean, Fredonia scored. Each team scored one touchdown, I believe, in the second half.
Yeah. Friday Night Lights, both teams have brought their A games.
And no quit. No quit on either side. I mean, this game has lived up to everything we thought. And it's, you know, Southwestern now with no timeouts left, not only do they have to score here, they have to recover an onside kick. There's no, I mean, Fredonia can kneel it down if they get the ball. So it's not only score, recover the onside, and score again. Here we go. Let's see what Southwestern has now.
It looks to me that Matt Panis, number four, is a little injured out there.
Low snap. Kenny goes down and gets it. Fires the ball to an open receiver over the middle, though. So he's going to be tackled in bounds. It's a first down, though. So that'll temporarily stop the clock. That was, I think, Ashton Matthews with the completion. So Southwestern gets right to line of scrimmage. 35 seconds left. Clock's running. I think he's going to clock it here, and he does. 32 seconds left. Southwestern still down by two. It's going to be second down after the clock. No timeouts left.
Yeah, and you can see both teams are really starting to feel this game. There's going to be some ice bucket baths.
Absolutely.
After this one.
There's going to be a lot of kids laying around on a Saturday tomorrow, without a doubt. Some will have bigger smiles on the face than others, but there's going to be a lot of players laying around after this one. Here we go. Second down and 10. 32 seconds left. Fredonia up by two. Scores. 14 overall. Kenny takes a snap back. All the time in the world. Rolling out now. He's going to go for it, and he gets the corner. And he's still on his feet, and he is in the end zone.
Unreal.
Aiden Kennedy once again. Taking, putting this game on his shoulders and make another outstanding play.
I was just going to say the same thing.
You know, he gets the edge, beats Sam Ezrock, comes up. Ethan Fry comes up here, loses his footing.
Just real elusive.
And, you know, that's Matt Lauder, too, that couldn't bring Aiden Kennedy down. So now 18 seconds left. Very important extra point here to bring the game within seven. They need this kick.
They're going for two.
Unless they're going to go
like,
for two.
Which I don't quite understand.
But then they could win it with another score. That's, you know.
You got to get two somewhere.
No, well, you didn't to tie it.
I got you.
Yeah, they're up four. They were up 14. Right now they're up.
Interesting.
Timeout. Fredonia, I believe. You know what? That's not a bad timeout.
You can't take them home with
right,
you.
Right. Yeah, so, I mean, in theory, in their eyes, we got if we don't get it here, they still could get a touchdown and a two-point to tie it. So they're definitely looking for the win. And this onside kick coming up is so bigger than the two-point play. Mm-hmm. Fredonia has to recover this onside kick.
And we know that the Southwestern kicker can onside kick it.
Yeah, does a very nice job. Again, not only have to cover with a one- or two-play touchdown, right? So, I mean,
well, yes.
I'm with you, though.
Yeah,
yes.
Yeah. Fredonia gets it, game over. One kneel down, no timeouts left. Southwestern gets it. They have a legitimate shot to not tie and or win this game, depending on this play right here. You know, and you know the ball's going to be in Aiden Kennedy's hands here one way or the other. How could it not be? And remember when Ethan Fry slipped on that early interception attempt too. Okay, he takes a snap. It's a low snap. He's able to get it. He's looking to his right. Good coverage there. And he gets the pass off. He's going to be tackled short. What a play.
Nice,
I mean, all around. Aiden Kenny made a nice play. Nice catch and another and a tackle by Micah Davis
Paulo
to keep
him
on the end zone.
Yanking him down. So we have an almost sack.
Here it is right here. Bad snap.
Kennedy got the ball out.
Looking there. Palouk's all over him. Holding on. How's he even able to get that off? Catch and a great job by Micah Davis
keeping
him out of the end zone.
Did catch that too.
Yeah, absolutely.
I thought I saw a bobble, but he did catch that.
So now it all comes down to this.
It's a game of inches.
Yes, it is. And how exciting even that no good two-point conversion just was.
Yeah. This has been an exciting second half here.
Yeah, well, you know, thanks. It was a much, you know, more Fredonia until you joined us in the second half here, though. If they get the onside, you have to leave the booth.
There you go.
So now the ever-important with special teams. One last special teams play has to be made here by one team or the other to give Southwestern any chance to win.
Now, do you take a few of the big linemen out and put
absolutely.
It just a whole
hands?
You got to get a hand.
Yeah, there's no one out there that can't handle a football, at least there shouldn't
low
be.
Low-digit numbers.
But there is a couple. I mean, you got Juan Mendez in there up front. You got Alex Palouquis. We've seen him catch a few balls. And you got Owen Rush, who is
13 Quinn out there.
Yeah, all hands. You got one. You got Ronsky's the only player back, in case they go
a
little
nice
deeper.
Game. Ronsky's had a very nice game as well.
So here, you know, it's like one of those movies. Who's this Huckleberry? Who's he rifling this onside kick at? Right?
Do they have the same rule? They can't overload, can they?
We had the wrong tee out there. How much time do you get on this? No delay game on onside kicks, huh?
It would appear.
Yeah, so there's definitely more on our side to the kicker's left. One, two, three, four, five, six players to our side, and the kicker makes seven. Four on the far side to the kicker's right.
I'm surprised at how many linemen are out there.
I am too. And they're all right next to each other. I bet the ball's coming right at those linemen. Let's see, and it does.
Great onside. They got it. They got it. Great onside kick.
Number 88 of Southwestern, I believe, recovered that. But like
it's almost a squibber.
Yeah, that
and not only they get it, with 13 seconds left, the ball's at the 34-yard line of the Hillbillies.
No timeouts.
Don't get why the linemen were out there.
Yeah, I don't either, you know.
First down from the 34-yard line.
Perfect kick, like you said, though.
It was a
perfect
kick. I mean, that thing hopped the way it's
supposed to hop. 13 seconds left. Now if you're Fredonia, I mean, Kennedy's torturing you with giving them all day. Do you bring some pressure here?
I would like to see at least the next show, maybe not three.
Well, the other piece of it is if you don't bring, you let Kennedy wind up. Mm-hmm. And we've just watched his elusiveness.
Yeah.
You give him the three-man rush. He drops back. He sits on it a few seconds. He's looking. Let's spread out everybody on the defense. Now I get to run around and do my magic. So
His legs have been killing.
Right.
Killing right. Fredonia yeah. here and, in the second
and
half.
And the more spread that Fredonia defense is, the easier it is for him to work his deal.
Well, and you know, another thing we talked about early, but Alex Paluk, who has been an outstanding defensive end, is he's battling through it. But he has 1.5 legs at most right now, chasing an Aiden Kennedy around. That's really giving Kennedy a little bit more time there also. Here we go, folks. Fredonia is up by 8. 13 seconds left.
Two plays?
Yep. Yeah.
Well, it depends. Incomplete quick pass, you know. Motion to the right. Kenny takes, drops the snap. He's able to get back. Plenty of time, like we talked about. Wheel route is on. It is complete and out of bounds. 5 seconds left. Ball's going to be right around us.
He was wide open.
Yes.
By, you know,
16,
the
17 yard line. Really, now we're probably down to one play left here. One more play. Who's going to make it? Fredonia or Southwestern?
Looking right now how big that two-point conversion is.
Right,
yeah,
right.
Absolutely. So, yeah, not only they have to score, they also had to convert on the two-point conversion. So, really, they got to score two plays in a row here to tie the game.
Got the Fredonia faithful down in the end zone making some noise.
Yes, they do. Kenny's looking. Look, he's got all sorts of room to run. This is it. Lauder gets a big block.
He's in.
And it's a touchdown. Aiden Kennedy leaps over the Fredonia defense for the touchdown. Down by 2. No time left. Untimed down for Southwestern to tie this game.
Here we go. Right.
Aiden Kennedy scrambles for the touchdown.
And what a turn of events. Fredonia was up by 3 scores.
That was a very athletic play. Very athletic play. But Fredonia defense says to dig deep here. See if they can
one play. Yeah.
One play, game, one and play. That doesn't mean anything, right?
Or we'll be going to little Southern Dutch. See what each team can do here.
One last play here. Aiden Kennedy back to each side of him. He's going to get it, and he's going to run it.
No.
And he stopped short.
Didn't get it.
And the game is over. Fredonia holds on. Two consecutive two-point conversion stop for a huge Fredonia Hillbilly win.
Wow. Got me nervous.
Oh, you nervous. So I have a 2 sons playing.
Man.
But I'm telling you right now, full props to Aiden Kennedy.
That guy's
what
a gamer.
What a game.
That guy's
what
a gamer.
What a second half. What a fourth quarter.
Yeah, he'll be
by
playing.
That young
he'll be
man.
Playing at the next level.
You know, Aiden Kennedy, outstanding game. Fredonia Hillbillies, way to hang on. Huge, huge win here in the Orange Bowl. You made it interesting. But wow.
If you stayed, it was a good game, that's for sure.
Absolutely. And like you said, look at the Fredonia faithful in the end zone celebrating.
I thought they would keep it spread out here.
Let them roll out. Yeah. I agree.
They went up the gut.
Right at them.
They had an extra fullback on that one, and it turned out, and Fredonia made the nice stop.
Yeah, and I'd love to see who made that. I think it was 2 or 3 guys that made that tackle, unfortunately.
That's a team effort.
Yeah.
Boy, I was struggling.
I'm shaking, guys.
He must have
Kennedy's
ran for 200 yards.
He only had 137. He threw for 227. So that's, so unofficial, but 264 yards of offense.
Well, he's going to definitely get, a Connolly Cup nominee, I would say, for this game.
I was going to mention definitely some Western York recognition.
Before we get too crazy, Whitfield also had a pretty good game, including 3 touchdowns rushing. So, I mean, it came early. We're giving full credit to Kennedy. At the end, he certainly manned up.
I would.
But they got ahead.
Yeah, Jake Burkholz, head coach. He had his team ready. He never quit. They had their team playing second half the whole time. This handshake is well earned by both teams.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, Fredonia got up early. They let Southwestern back in it. But you know what? Southwestern made a lot of plays to get back in it too.
Right.
And those penalties, you think about it early, it did cost Fredonia some points early on. Yeah. you know, and the penalties haunted. They, I mean, you had Southwestern maybe one official penalty today, at most maybe two, and Fredonia had countless penalties, and that kept Southwestern in this game, guys. And sooner or later, that is going to cost the Hillbillies. But, yeah. But now Southwestern has two losses in league, lost to Fredonia. Salamanca lost to Fredonia, had to. So that is really, I mean, Fredonia is, they haven't clinched, but they have two league games left.
5-0 looks
yeah,
good.
Yeah, absolutely.
4-0 looks good.
In the league, and then Dunkirk 9 league game at the end of the season. So another exciting win by Fredonia clinches first place because they have the head-to-head
right
over Salamanca. So that's a huge win. They don't feel as good as they wanted to or probably thought they were going to by the end.
A win versus Southwestern is a win.
Absolutely. And what a game. I can't get over that game and that ending.
Oh, thanks for having me, guys.
Yeah, thanks for coming
in. Thanks for coming in. No, so what – hey, Pat, you – we're a player here. What are the emotions going through after? So,
there's no better emotion. You know, you're feeling.
There's not a chance that they're right now.
Overjoyed. They just want to go hang out with the buds.
Ice up.
Go to that locker room.
No risk that the last couple of series are going to carry over and give them some kind of a hangover?
Not for a while, because, you know, they play Chautauqua Lake next. If Chautauqua Lake even feels that game, if they forfeit, that seals the division.
Right.
Now, Casadega Faulkner is not completely out of this. They have a good record so far, but they got some games to make up as well, and they got to play Salamanca on the Tuesday and then come back play Fredonia on Saturday. Now, Fredonia might play Chautauqua Lake on that same Tuesday, but that's a huge advantage for Fredonia, getting Casadega Faulkner and a must-win against Salamanca. It's going to be a physical game, and then have to come back and beat Fredonia as well.
So thanks, Pat. Pat Mahaney joined us today, former quarterback for the Hillbillies. Chip Riewoldt ran the show. Thanks, Chip, for getting us the camera. And Jackson Hickey and Anthony Derby, right? Anthony Derby did another great job today. Wonderful game. Lots of fun late.
We're going to be talking about this one for a long time, guys.
This is Greg Krause and Shannon Davis signing off, and see you next time.
All right. Thank you, gentlemen.